We welcome you to Waco, Texas, and the Big 12 now on ESPN+. College football season opener for the Baylor Bears at home at McLane Stadium, taking on the Lumberjacks of Stephen F. Austin. Hi, everybody. I'm Joel Myers alongside Super Bowl champion Barrett Brooks, and welcome to Waco, Texas. Last year, Baylor, one of the best stories in all of college football, Barrett. 2 years ago, Matt Rhule's first year, they're 1-11. Won a bowl game last year, finished the season at 7-6, and scored 45 points in that bowl victory. Offense was not a problem for them last year. Stopping people, that's another story.
Absolutely, and that's exactly why Coach Phil Snow changed his defensive philosophy. He was a four-down guy, so because of these numbers you're about to see, he changed everything up. He went to a 3-3-5 defense where they had three defensive linemen, three linebackers, and five guys. They're not just linebackers, safeties, and corners, but a mixture of all of them because he wanted to get his best athletes on the field, which will allow them to go out there and play a lot better, play a lot faster. When you have the best athletes out there, it gives you a chance to go out there and make some – hopefully turnovers rather than last year where they were the worst at everything.
Yeah, they were at the bottom of the Big 12 in creating turnovers last year, and also at the bottom of the Big 12 in giving up plays of more than 40 yards. Offensively, though, they've got continuity. In fact, they bring back 10 of 11 starters, and the quarterback is a leader. He's got good wheels, of 4.6 40 in Charlie Brewer.
Exactly. If you look at him, he's 6 foot, about 205 pounds, really good athlete. Understands now how to run the offense. They opened it up for him. He now knows how to go out there and call his own plays. He also understands how to do protections. It's not just the center making those protection calls. He is now advanced enough, and what his philosophy is to let him go out there and get his best athletes in the greatest position he can. Now he can call these calls, pick up blitzes, and now get it to his best players. This has allowed them to go ahead and do it what they want to do, and that's get the ball to his best players.
Matt Rhule and the Bears ready to go. Their home opener. We kick off the college football season in just a moment in Waco, Texas.
TFNB, your bank for life, is the official local bank of Baylor Athletics. With four locations around Central Texas to serve you. Come by our tailgate before every home game for food, fun, and games. Located right outside Gate D, you can't miss our tent. And look for our new location opening this fall just across I-35 from campus. TFNB, your bank for life, the official local bank of Baylor Athletics.
Toyota's national clearance event is on. Now's the time to get great deals on the last of the 2019s, including our most popular models like the adventurous RAV4, stylish Highlander, sporty Camry, and more. During Toyota's national clearance event, get $1,000 customer cash, or qualified lessees can lease the new 2019 RAV4 LE for only $259 a month. The deals end September 3rd. Get yours before they're gone. Toyota, let's go places.
Welcome back once again to Waco, Texas. A warm, sultry Saturday afternoon.
Yes.
Very warm one. The Lumberjacks are used to it, though. Let's face it, Nacogdoches, about a three-hour drive to get here, bust over. 91 feels like 96, feels like 106 for us. Humidity not bad, considering we're in Texas. And Barrett, it's going to be interesting as Colby Carthel makes his debut, and Matt Rhule can relate to this just a couple of years ago. Colby, an unbelievable success story.
Absolutely.
At Texas A&M Commerce, won a national championship in 2017.
Yes, you know, and him coming here, he brought some enthusiasm to this team. That's why they brought him in. The fact that he goes out there, he's more energetic than his kids, actually. So when you look at him as a coach, his big thing is play at a level of excellence, making sure that you know that you're going to go out there and execute in the way in which he wants him to.
Success at Temple, it's carried over, great second season. And now, all of a sudden the expectations have changed for the Baylor Bears, haven't they?
Yes, he's going into his third year. He's got a lot more of his guys in there as opposed to the previous regime. And they're finally bought into what he wants to do in his coaching philosophy. So they're starting to play better now. He started to turn his program around just like he did the Temple program.
Baylor is going to kick it away. Back deep over to the far side, Remy Simmons, a junior from Chicago, along with Xavier Gibson. So here we go. And make a Tamrick Pace, the senior from Brownsboro, Texas. It'll be kicked away by Noah Rauschenberg, true freshman from Tulsa. So here we go. College football season kicks off in Waco, Texas. You know, what an atmosphere anyway. On-campus stadium, a beautiful one. McLean Stadium. And over the head of the deep man, as it's going to be out to the 25-yard line, first and 10.
I'm really anxious to see what this offense is going to do. We haven't seen with these players, so I'm trying to really make sure that I see the development this team has and if they really picked up on what Coach Carthel wants to do as an offensive unit.
Good tall quarterback at 6'4", Trey Self out of North Richland Hills, Texas. Last couple of years played, and it's so competitive in the Junior College Conference in Kansas, and he was at Butler Community College, always a really good program.
Yes.
And he succeeded. Program. Yeah, he succeeded there from the 25, first and 10. Single to the backfield. Man penetration to the backfield, but they miss Thomas Hutchings. Senior from Cedar Park, Texas, did a good job with yards after contact for about 3 to the 28, brought down by Bravian Roy, the underneath tackle.
Yeah, they ran pistol formation, which the quarterback and shotgun with the running back behind them, and they run a stretch play. And that's kind of what the expectations of the defensive coordinator Phil Snow wanted. They're going to run this bounce play, try to see if they can cover on the backside, and then make sure they get in and cut. But penetration always kills run plays, and that's exactly what Baylor did.
They've got the tight end set up in the backfield over to the left side like a H-back. Throwing on second and long on the out pattern. It's wide of the intended target, trying to get it to Pace over to the far side.
Yeah, he's one of their star players. They want to get it to him. He's a really good athlete, big receiver. Get into his hands early, see if he can get out there and make these DBs miss.
Good job, Tejada, on the coverage, the junior from Frisco, Texas. So now a third and long. They don't want to go three and out on the road on a warm day. We'll get into how you made sure that you were hydrated going into a matchup like this.
Absolutely.
It's going to be third and 7 from the 28. Will noise be a factor? Tall one. And they're going to be well short of the first down. Going up to pull it in. And a good job over to the far side. Calvin Clater, sophomore from Fort Worth. But he's dropped immediately.
And that's exactly what they want to do. They drop back. And the defense wants them to catch it in front of them. They don't want him to get in the seams when they go out there. Playing zone. He sits in the soft zone. But as soon as he catches it, he has two players up there to make a play on him. That's exactly what they want to do, especially this senior right here, Clay Johnson. Really good player, really good linebacker.
Senior from Abilene. He led the lumber on him after the good coverage initially by Tejada once again, the cornerback on that side. So now going back deep and waiting for the punt from Max Quick. It's a wobbler. They'll stay away from it. It's a short one, very short one.
It might have been partially blocked. And this is a major concern. Yeah, this is a major concern for the SFA offense and their special teams. They wanted to see if their special teams could really hold up because this is exactly what Baylor does. And they understand that if they can create pressure in special team situations, now they can get some turnovers early. And they just had a block punt here.
That's a redshirt freshman, Max Quick, who had it deflected. Charlie Brewer, natural leader, good wheels, as I mentioned. And then the confidence factor that his coaches talked about with us yesterday.
They love that. We want to see how many if he calls and changes plays up.
Bullet over to the far side. Tall one pulled in by Denzel Mims, a senior from Dangerfield, Texas. So guys on the Biletnikoff watch list pulled it down in front of the safety, Trenton Gordon.
He sat in the pocket. Even though the defense had a little pressure on him, one of the guards got beat. He was still able to execute the throw and get it out of his hands.
Need two. Man, will they give him enough? Right at the first down marker is Jamichael Hasty, a fifth-year senior from Longview, Texas. They're going to go with Pace. They're not going to huddle. They'll go in a hurry up right now as Breeze, or the defensive end, wrapped him up. Need a little less than a yard and flag down on the play. It looked like a flag over to the near side. He picked it up, though. And will they give him the first down or not?
Great penetration.
Yes, moving it. Yeah, good job, because barely inches across.
And that's kind of the strength of this defense. They have some guys that played before and are pretty good. You know, they just have to get that confidence, gain that confidence and buy into the system.
From the 35, starting in plus territory, Brewer with a double clutch and, once again, resourceful for Hasty. He didn't want to go there initially, but going through the progressions very quickly, Hasty was the last resort.
If you watch this, the defensive line are moving and they're getting penetration, beating guys out their stance. And that's what you want to do when you're a smaller defensive line. Get up the field, create penetration, get some pressure on Brewer. Now you're going to make him make an immediate decision and, you know, and make sure he makes the right decision.
Two in the backfield for the first time. Man, a huge hole up the middle, bolting inside the 20. First down. That was John Lovett. A guy that plays offense, can play defense, and has before, and a single digit. We'll get into that.
Yeah, I mean, he's a South Jersey kid, slashing runner. Penetration kills run plays, but it also puts you on different levels.
Worked against him, wide open to the flat, Ebner. Ebner at the 10, will he get there? Touchdown, Baylor!
Wow, that was a great play. Get your one of your best athletes out there, one-on-one, in coverage, and he's able to beat the corner and go in to score. Follows blocking. Watch out to get a couple of offensive linemen, slam them down with the run fake, which Osmond got out there one-on-one against a linebacker. And he's able to make a move, leave him sitting sitting right there on his feet, and go for the score. They talk about him being a really, really good playmaker, and they wanted to make sure that they can keep him occupied with that linebacker one-on-one, which they got some great success with the touchdown.
John Mayer's in for the point after. Redshirt freshman. And punches it through. Not a bad beginning. A short field, though, and remember, they can't afford that. Stephen F. Austin put in a bad spot to begin with. A breakdown in special teams. And the Baylor Bears capitalized.
And did you get caught on the back of a winless game during pregame? Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% more on car insurance.
This is the Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. And what a location. Baylor, just about 100 miles from Dallas, about 100 miles from Austin, about a three-hour drive from San Antonio. Just incredibly convenient location as the Bears move 45 yards after they got a break on special teams, made a big play, and now going back deep for Stephen F. Austin. On the return, it's going to be Xavier Gibson, the wide receiver, waiting for the kick from Noah Rauschenberg, a true freshman, will handle the kickoffs. And any long field goals, it'll be Rauschenberg. Man, it's going to be brought back about a yard into the end zone. Nothing doing, though, for Gibson, the wide receiver, as he's pushed down just across the 15 at about the 16-yard line by Henry Black, the safety. Well, in talking to Colby Carthel, the new head coach, there were some defections, let's face it.
Yeah.
30 guys, that's a lot. 30 guys, right?
Yeah, you know, and you try to run out the bad apples in the bunch. You want to make sure you have your guys that are going to buy into your system. And sometimes you run away some good players. And right now, these guys stuck it out, and they're going to be the guys that they're going to go forward with. So it happens sometimes, you know. Plus, some guys had to, get drug tested also during that time period. So we have to see what's going on with that.
Right. They did that the day after they took over. Remy Simmons, the wide receiver, took it in. He was popped right away by Blake Lynch. So you brought it up. The 3-3-5, they want to get more playmakers on the field. They need to create turnovers. Baylor dead last. They only had 10 takeaways last year.
Yes, they were a four-down team. They switched to a three-down team, three-down alignment team, which allows them to put faster guys, more athletic guys out there who can run and make some plays in space. Now you have the potential to maybe get some interceptions and create turnovers.
On second and long, make it third and longer. Thomas Hutchings, senior running back at 5'10", 205, with deep penetration to the backfield, dropped by Lynch first. And James Lynch, the junior from Round Rock, all he was first-team all-conference last year in the Big 12.
You watch, this is outside zone, and man, I tell you what, Clay Johnson rips right through the line, reads it perfectly, gets out there to really stop him. Penetration kills run plays, and Clay Johnson understands if he can get up the field, stop him. That's, he's starting already. This is his senior year, first tackle behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
Yeah, his dad's got plenty of experience in NFL locker rooms. We'll talk about that in just a moment. From the eight, it'll be third and forever. Heat on the quarterback and up for grabs over his shooting Calvin Clater, the wide receiver. But back to Clay Johnson. His dad was a strength coach in the NFL for better than 20 years.
Yes, I remember in San Diego. He's one of those guys, huge effort guys. So you can absolutely be for sure that Clay Johnson will be in shape and ready to rock and roll on every play. This kid has really grown as he has become a linebacker, especially in the middle of this defense. He's a playmaker, and they expect him to make a lot of plays in this defense. He's the Mike linebacker, captain on the team, and one of those single-digit guys, number four.
Back deep for Baylor. It's going to be Graylin Arnold, the safety. So Max Quick got rid of it in a hurry. Low-line drive, returnable type. Arnold from the 40. Making a miss at the 50, and then loses his footing. Boy, some good footwork, though, by Graylin Arnold, the defensive back, and Baylor's got it back.
Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus is a must for Big 12 fans. It is home to more than Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus is a must for Big 12 fans. It is home to more than 50 men's basketball games, 200-plus women's basketball and Olympic sports events, original content, coaches' press conferences, and shows. Big 12 Now is available on your phone, tablet, desktop, or TV-connected devices. Sign up today at ESPNplus.com.
How about those Jayhawks? Les Miles in his debut with the Jayhawks with a win. Little pitch to the outside. A lot of room for Chris Platt and out of bounds. So that was an interesting adjustment. All of a sudden, the dive play and the quarterback's out in the flank.
When you can run the ball, get the defense going one direction, and then throw across, pitch across to, it really puts you in a predicament on defense. Because if you don't make sure you follow your keys, it's going to be hard for you to react on plays just like that when your eyes can deceive you. Play your position first. Don't do what you're not supposed to do.
That's a 6-year senior who made that play. And he can't hang on this time. Chris Platt, the senior from Willis, Texas. So here's a guy who last year had 36 catches. He's had injuries, but it's nice that he wanted to stick around.
Yes,
and be a part of it.
Big-time weapon. Has a little speed. A big receiver at that. Had a great game in the bowl game and really highlighted, you know, that offense. So if they can get him going, he could be a major factor for this offense.
It'll be 2nd and 10. Drive started to the 44-plus territory. Little option action over to the far side. Hasty trying to make a miss. And yards after contest. He almost got him by the face mask. Pulled away, though. So good yardage and brought down by Jones. Quinn Jones, the strong side backer.
Look, get the offensive line going one way, and then the quarterback turns around, options it to Hasty. Now, Hasty's a quick player, but they play great disciplined football on this run play, which allowed him to do it. If that defensive line would have moved any more out to the outside, inside, he wouldn't have been able to recover on the outside.
It's tough to get a 5'9 guy who's got good breaks.
Right, exactly.
Nice stop. It'll be 3rd and about 4. Brewer in the flat and a first down. In goes his Treston Ebner, the junior from Henderson, Texas. Bert Morris, middle backer out of Amarillo. The sophomore brought him down, but they moved the chains again.
He's going to have a great game. And what they're doing on Baylor's offense, they've got two backs in the backfield running 21 personnel, two running backs, one tight end, which makes your defense account for two running backs. Now both linebackers are man-to-man. It really puts you in a predicament.
Red zone, you saw the numbers for Baylor last year. On the play fake, corner of the end zone, touchdown Baylor.
Great.
It's R.J. Sneed, the sophomore from Cypress.
Great play, great pass, put it right in the bread box. You couldn't ask for a better throw. Look at him, and it was tight protection. You look at him, he's sitting back there, tight coverage, but this guy made a great, great play. That's what you do. You want your quarterback to put it right in the bread box. That's exactly where Brewer put it. You see how he's definitely advanced in his reads, definitely advanced on his ball placement. He's a very accurate quarterback, even though he's one of the better athletic quarterbacks in the Big 12.
Now, the man about to kick, John Mayers, redshirt freshman, but he got into the bowl game. In fact, when the regular place kicker was hurt last year, he got in and hit 3 extra points. So he had some experience and success late in the season in the win over Vandy in the Texas Bowl. R.J. Sneed on the catch, the throw.
First
Charlie Brewer, you got it.
Get your quarterback down there.
14-0 Baylor.
Tonight's game, that's Jim Bailey to make line.
14-0, early lead for Baylor, very early. I'm not even 7 minutes into the game, and I love what the Baylor band's doing. They're in shorts and a T-shirt. Foresight, it's 90-plus degrees. Good for those individuals, those young women and young men. Charlie Brewer already with a couple of touchdown tosses, one to Ebner, the last one to R.J. Sneed. And you see, those wide receivers and tailbacks are smart. They're sitting next to that quarterback on the bench, aren't they?
You have to.
Don't forget about me. What a day. Start of college football. And a good kickoff once again by Noah Rauschenberg. Well, one of the big benefits of Big 12 now on ESPN Plus, it's access to the coach we've got on the sideline today, Matt Rhule. You can catch his weekly press conference. It's live every Monday morning during the football season, 11:30 Eastern, 10:30 here, Central Time Zone. And just one more reason, sign up at ESPNplus.com today and you get the Big 12 now. And we really enjoyed it. We spent a lot of time with Matt yesterday and his two coordinators, Jeff Nixon, Phil Snow, appreciated their time. They've got a good thing going. And let's not forget, Matt Rhule succeeded at a high level at a basketball school. Sorry to put it that way.
at Temple, yes. He did pretty good at Temple, yes.
Thank you. First and 10. And on the roll, perfect throw. Grab made, and then the lumber is laid on the wide receiver on the far side. Exceptional catch on that side by Preston Weeks.
Well, that's why you stop the penetration from your defense. You have to go out there, get them going one direction, and then stop with the boot, sit back, and then take your time to diagnose what's going on. He was able to get them out there one-on-one in between the zone and make a big play. They needed that to get this offense going for them.
So first down, and it was actually Xavier Gibson out of the flank. He's in the slot now. Nice move in the backfield. The running back, Thomas Hutchings, little adjustment to the left. Good yardage on first down.
Love it.
The way to the 45.
Love it. You know, since this defense is penetrating so hard, they ran a trap play. Get him going up the field, bring an offensive lineman from the backside, trap the guy, and run right behind him. Now you start setting the tempo, getting this offense going. Positive plays is how you beat a team. If you keep getting these positive plays, then you start getting your mindset, all right, we might be able to compete with this Baylor team.
Almost four on the carry. Call it second. Van Sex put the tight end in motion. And waggle it out. Tight end was free. Next layer overshoots.
Oh.
The young man who made the catch, Gibson. Boy, and he was available.
Yeah, he was. You know, they ran three levels in which he could throw to. They had a tight end running a little out route. Then they had on the top of him, he had two out routes at three different levels in the zone. He could have picked any three of them. He just overthrew one or underthrew the other.
And you like the arm strength you see from Trey Self.
Exactly.
It'll be third and six. See, you don't know where they're coming from in the new 3-3-5. That's what Phil Snow said. It's unpredictable. Back off, but they constantly move, don't they? They give over to the right side. Inside the 40, and the dive is good for the first down from Thomas Hutchings.
Wow.
Yards after contact.
You just got to go out there and fight. And at this point, Baylor went up there and make sure that they have a lot of guys on the line so you don't know where they're coming from. What you do on offense, run outside zone. Pick your hole, which allows you to go up there, hit it up in there. And sometimes you got to get those tough yards. You're going to get hit once, but you got to run through the first tackle, get some quality yards, keep the sticks going. As long as they do that, they have the ball. It keeps Baylor's offense off the field.
It started with a big completion to Xavier Gibson. Now on first down, an adjustment over to the left side. Bouncing outside, big yardage, and close to another first down is Josh McGowan. He's brought down by the safety, Chris Miller. McGowan, a junior from McAllen, Texas.
Love it. Up front, they're getting these big guys going. There you saw Lagarde pull around on the trap play. They're able to hit it up in there. And now they get in between the different zones in that defense, in that 3-3 defense. Once you get that penetration, guys are on different levels. Now you can run in between those levels, which will give you positive run yardage.
First and 10 at the 27. Drive started back of their own 25. McGowan again. Handoff, he held it up high. McGowan almost on his shoulder pad brings it down. Jordan Williams, the outside backer, makes the stop, but encouraging signs for Stephen F. Austin.
Yes. I mean, they could have been a bad play because penetration beat the guard inside, but he was able to cut off the backside. When he cut off of it, it gave him at least 3 yards. You know, any yardage, just positive yardage, you're in a better place than you were when you started.
It'll be second. Long six. Backside pressure came and in and out of the hands as he went to Cody Williams. And check that, actually. He went for, it looked like 82, but instead 85. And it's Borders, the wide receiver. Quintivian Borders.
He's got to catch that. Keep the chains moving. Those are little things that you beat yourself with, which will not let give you an opportunity to compete with this Baylor team. Take all they can give you and don't give anything back. And they just gave some yardage back with that drop.
So call it third. The long six, almost seven. Pocket holds up. Middle of the field's available. Complete first and goal. Great grab inside by Tamarick Pace.
Definitely a great, great play. If you look at it, he sits down in that zone. When he sits down there, allows him given an opportunity to get the ball to him. Offensive line played well, switched off the slants, and then he sat right back in that zone in between the linebacker and the safety, which allowed him to have the big yardage on this play.
And give it, actually, it was Remy Simmons, 998. We're about eight stories up. So Thomas Hutchings takes over in the backfield. In the red zone last year, the numbers for Stephen F. Austin, not good enough, of course. On 30, inside the 20. Little option action. Breaking yards after contact, and then belted on the outside as Hutchings once again. Chris Miller, the safety, coming up.
Now Trey Self gets the offensive line, going to the right, and then pitches it back behind it to left. Get a little misdirection so you can make this defense read their keys. Now you slow them down a little bit, then you can have some experience with them going up and stop them from penetrating so much. If you can do that, it gives you an opportunity now to get big yardage.
You see the defensive lineman down on the knee. It is unbelievably warm downstairs right now. Can't blame. Long drive. Best drive so far for Stephen F. Austin. Huge hole. And dashing inside the five, down to the three is Hutchings once again. And it brings up a third and goal. He's wrapped up by the inside linebacker, Henry Black.
Running that bounce play. Love the run plays, because if you can keep your offense on the field, keep Bender's offense off the field, and then you get the guys down front, those defensive linemen, breathe a little harder, because now they have to play all these plays. They're going to get a little tired because it is hot out here. We'll see how they go with this, if they're going to run the same run play, get it up through the middle.
It'll be third and goal from the three. Looking into the corner of the end zone, running for DeSalve. He'll get there. Touchdown, Stephen F. Austin. You think Colby Carthel likes the first score, the first points of his tenure as the head coach of the Lumberjacks?
Oh, now they know they can compete. It's just a regular drop back pass, off the line. Big guy in the middle beats him, but then he has enough speed to get to the corner, going for the score.
Lost containment, didn't they?
You play man-to-man, everybody's backs turn. And that play, they were man-to-man, which allowed him, he's unaccountable because there's nobody to get him on the man play. He runs out because they didn't have a spy guy there. Now he can go out there and score because now they're different lanes and guys are turned around on the defense, which allowed him to score on that play.
Every scoring play is reviewed. They want to see if his knee was down first. And in the previous four games in this individual series between the two schools, Stephen F. Austin have been outscored 201-0. It's the first points they've ever scored against Baylor.
Now those guys are starting to believe a little bit.
Storm Ruiz makes it a seven-point game. So a long drive, 75-yard drive. The last 3 yards belong to Trey Self in his debut as the quarterback for the Jacks of Nacogdoches. Baylor Bears band in the background and a very good one at that. And welcome back to Waco, Texas. 14-7 lead for the Bears. Now let's see if Stephen F. Austin can get their special teams together, because the special teams have cost them. Short fields for Baylor, headed to their 45 of the Lumberjacks at the 44 of Stephen F. Austin. Short fields plus territory scored both times. So the first they've ever had. They were outscored 201-0 over the first four matchups between the two schools.
Unbelievable. So that's really a win in their books anyway. They scored on them. Now this team is starting to believe, really believe. That's all you can ask of a young team with a young coach. These guys are believing in this system. They just scored on the Baylor Bears.
Jones and Jermichael Hasty. It's going to be Jones over to the far side. Quinlan Jones, good yardage across the 25. And actually, it's Snead on the return.
Now Stephen F. Austin's defense have to come up here and get a turnover, or at least stop him.
7-point game, a little more than three to play. Well, they haven't done anything wrong yet offensively. That's Charlie Brewer and the Baylor Bears. So let's see now, with a longer field at least, but decent territory at their own 29. If Stephen F. Austin can get a stop on the play fake out in the flat, it's complete. Good yardage again across the 35 at a first down as it's taken in on the far side by Fleeks, the wide receiver. Brought down by Lawton, the cornerback on that side.
Charlie Brewer read what the defense was. It was zone. They were sitting back. Get it to your playmaker out the backfield, which allowed him to pick up some first down yardage.
Former co-offensive freshman of the year in the Big 12 in 2017, Brewer just throwing the ball away. Nothing available. Good coverage downfield. That's an incompletion because of coverage, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. And it just shows how smart and how Brewer's developed in his process of being a quarterback now. You know, you can't make a big play every play, so you don't have anything. Don't take a hit. Get the ball out your hands. Throw it over. Live to fight another day. Brewer's definitely matured a lot. Matured a whole lot during this last season, going into this season.
He has started 16 into the last 17, make it 17 of 18 now with the opener today in Waco, looking underneath and throws it wide of his intended target, a little bit behind Denzel Mims. I thought he was going to Snead, who was available, coming across.
Yeah, he missed that. He missed that read there, but he tried to back shoulder him. I see why he did it. One-on-one, one of your better receivers, but I'd have went with, you know, Clater. You know, he's a fast guy, so I thought he was going to beat him, but he back shouldered a little bit. He couldn't get the ball completed to him.
This is a huge third down now, Barrett, for Stephen F. Austin. And they call a timeout. This is big. With 2:40 to play, now they have confidence. Can they get a stop after one first down and get the ball back in decent field position?
Stephen F. Austin's defense is starting to get a little bit of that from the offense. It's contagious. Once one guy starts making things happen, it creates a fear, you know, for everybody on the team to start believing that they can go out there and play with this Baylor team. And at this point, I can see them doing that at this point.
Well, the Big 12 now on ESPN Plus, must have for Big 12 fans. Exclusive home, more than 50 men's basketball games, hundreds of other Big 12 sports, including women's basketball. Plus, original content like the weekly Les Miles All-Access Show during the college football season. And congratulations to a good guy, Les Miles, winning in Lawrence today. Sign up today at ESPNPlus.com.
So Les needed that.
Yeah, you said it. Indiana State. They beat Indiana State at home. It's been dry times. And they've got a nice facility, a nice compound now for football. Third and 10. Brewer underneath, tight end. And getting off the block, outstanding play by Artavius Hendricks. Honorable mention All-Southland Conference last season to hold Henley a yard shy.
I tell you what, you know, they have some big tight ends on this team. And he ran a little drag route across. Hands pretty good going across. I like the fact he held his composure. He didn't go to the deep pass. He went underneath. Litified it. Sometimes you have to punt. And it's not always a bad thing. But at least he didn't go down and make a mistake of trying to throw to a guy that's already covered.
Isaac Power ready to punt it away. It's fourth and a little more than a yard, almost two. Romello Bentley waits back deep. Man, one hopper. takes it across the 15 to the 20. Good yardage. Good field position. And also the punter, don't forget, once he's outside of the tackle box, he took a shot at the end.
Yeah, I mean, he can. He's considered a runner now.
You got it. Clay Johnston down on the coverage. Next Saturday, Big 12 Now on ESPN+. Well, it is Kansas. They're hosting Coastal Carolina. And, Barry, you're going to be in Stillwater, aren't you?
Yes, we will be down at Okie State.
Yep, Oklahoma State taking on McNeese. That starts at 7 o'clock Eastern. Both start at 7 o'clock Eastern, 6 Central. So sign up right now on ESPNplus.com for the Big 12 Now. So now Stephen F. Austin has their best field position to start a drive at their own 30-yard line. On first down. Looking for any kind of space. Hutchings brought down after a gain of maybe a yard at the most. Clay Johnston, the linebacker again. Boy, he is everywhere, the senior from Abilene. Led the Bears in stops last year. Fifth overall in the Big 12 in tackles.
Yeah, they went back to the well again. Run the run trap. See if they can get some movement.
Caught it second and close to 10. Self in trouble. Resourceful. Man, and get something when it looked like it was collapsing as Remy Simmons coming back. How about his quarterback? He's a junior from Chicago.
They get some pressure on the outside. Great play on the outside. Washes the tackle's hands down. He gets out the pocket, gets the ball to one of his athletes. That's what you want. Self, that's a great job of him understanding that he has a guy coming across the field and hit the open man.
Well, it was three and out the first two series for the Lumberjacks. Want to avoid it now with good field position. It's third and a long six. Underneath and off the backside and tracking the running back Hutchings. Outstanding effort. So the coverage, it was Terrell Bernard, a sophomore from LaPorte, Texas.
James Lynch is having a game right now on starting left tackle Zach Ingram. I mean, he's 6'7", very tall guy, and he's got to learn to get his hips down. He's getting bull rushed back. And that's the problem with being a tall guy like that and playing against a guy that's great with his hands. James Lynch is getting up under his pads, using his hands, and creating that pressure on Self. Now Self is starting to see ghosts and see this guy rushing from his left side.
He's a junior from Round Rock, Texas. They're after the punter again, who gets it away in time. Off the side of his foot, though, and great field position coming up once again with only 28 seconds left in the first quarter and a real good start. A couple of touchdown tosses early for Charlie Brewer.
Yeah, he's definitely executing his offense. You see his maturity level. He's calling plays. He got a one-on-one, the running back one-on-one, and is able to beat him for the touchdown. Once again, he saw where his one-on-one was and got it to his athlete. That's what you want. Charlie Brewer is definitely going to his zone as far as running this offense. He's creating matchups for the offense, getting his receivers one-on-one, running backs out of the backfield one-on-one, and taking advantage of them. Give them nice balls and throwing it right where they need to have it to execute the offense.
And right now, the special teams are not helping Stephen F. Austin at all. Plus territory for the third time over the first four series in the flat. Making a miss. Good job, Ebner. And out of bounds after a gain of about five. Treston Ebner, junior from Henderson, Texas. He had 49 catches over the last couple of years, so they know he can get it out of the backfield that way.
Absolutely, but you can't do that. He had a block on the outside, one-on-one, and you know, defensive player going to make the play, gets hit in the back, pushed in the back. It's not going to help you. Coach wanted to make sure at this point.
Holding, number 13, offense. 10-yard penalty from previous spot. Replay, first down.
Wide receiver on the outside blocking R.J. Snead.
Yeah, you know, and that's a big, huge point that Coach wanted to do. Coach Rule wanted to execute, not have all these penalties. And that's just a bad block. That's not, you know, having your head in the game.
Yeah, that was pretty obvious, wasn't it?
Right.
Well tackled.
Right.
So moving back from plus territory back to their own 41. First carry, no. A play fake going deep down the sideline, and there was contact there, but no flag thrown. Tyquan Thornton all tied up with Artavius Hendricks.
He's one of their better players. Hendricks is one of those guys that a really good athlete can play, but at this point, he's got to step his game up because they're going to put their best player on him, and he's got to go one-on-one with these guys all day.
Let him in breakups pass defense last year. Should be the final snap of a really entertaining first 15 minutes of play. Sneed's got it, but not much, and that'll do it. So now it's going to be third and long when we get started with the second 15 minutes. And what a start. Baylor at home against Stephen F. Austin. The Big 12 against the Southland Conference. And so far, it's the Big 12 by 7.
Toyota's national clearance event is on. Now's the time to get great deals on the last of the 2019s, including our most popular models like the Adventurous RAV4, Stylish Highlander, Sporty Camry, and more. During Toyota's national clearance event, get $1,000 customer cash, or qualified lessees can lease the new 2019 RAV4 LE for only $259 a month. The deals end September 3rd. Get yours before they're gone. Toyota, let's go places.
At Baylor, our lights shine
while we push our limits
and guide the way.
At Baylor, our lights shine as we're making connections
and making an impression
as leaders
and as part of something bigger.
Baylor's light shines around the world, but it starts in each of us. Baylor, where lights shine bright.
Thank you. Welcome back once again to Waco, Texas, in this beautiful ballpark. And they waited long enough, and they did it right. When they finally did it at Baylor, they did it right. It's on campus, McLean Stadium. It's only 90-plus degrees. Feels like it's about 120. And the loyalty factor of the Baylor Bears and the student body. Healthy situation, but it is on campus, and it is a perfect setting on the Brazos River. So Joel Myers, Super Bowl champion Barrett Brooks, and a third and 17, a screenplay. Not a bad call. Ebner, will he get there? Going to be shy. This is interesting because you're in plus territory. Shy by about six. Maybe put him back deep with a punt.
Another victory for Stephen F. Austin. You've held this Baylor team. Supposed to be in high-powered offense. Making a punt again. It was already in plus territory for him. This is definitely a win for that defense.
Now let's see if he can put it out of bounds or at least sky it high enough that there's no return. Special teams playing up big right now because of the lack in the punt game. It's a high one, but a short one. Bentley won't get near it, and it's out of bounds. So a break Could have been a lot worse. A lot worse. They're going to put it out of bounds at the 24 for Colby Carthel. Coach is fired up, and that's Matt Rhule, now in his third year at Baylor. 7-6, bowl winners last year. And he said to us, listen, yesterday he told us, I lost to an FCS school when I was the coach at Temple. I'm not taking any opponent lightly.
No, he's not. And he specifically told us that he does not want to go in and have a sloppy game. And you saw that penalty where the block in the back put his offense back. That just gives Stephen F. Austin just a little bit more thinking they can compete with this Baylor team.
First and 10. Self in trouble again and on his way down. Yeah, you brought it up earlier. And
James
he's in
Lynch.
The, you got it. He's in the backfield. First team all Big 12 last year. James Lynch wouldn't let go, would he? Led the Bears in sacks last season.
You know, you show him, he's 6'7", getting under the pad. Great pass rushing moves. Look, turns the corner around him, turns his hips, and is able to get to Self. There's nothing Self can do about that. You know, he's trying to go through his progressions, trying to get the ball out of his hands. But he's beating him too fast. At this point, James Lynch is having the game of his life.
Not a round rock at 6'4", 295. Led him in tackles behind the line of scrimmage last year. And Self adjusting with one of his trips to the wide side of the field. Now, blitz coming from the opposite side. And the deep one picked off, going the other way. Intercepted. And down. On the pick and the takeaway, Blake Lynch, a linebacker.
It was kind of self-explanatory where Self was going. Lynch reads the play, reads the tight end. The tight end went back and told him where he wanted to go. Knew he had a one-on-one against the linebacker. Linebacker undercuts the play. It's a bad throw, really, and for the interception. This is exactly what you didn't want from your offense. Stephen F. Austin. Lynch made that play also.
Get it at the 34 after the pick by the senior from Gilmer, Texas. So now four out of the five drives has started in plus territory for Baylor. Will it be a jet? No. Fake on the jet and throw it at the feet of the man who was coming across on the jet sweep. And that was John Lovett.
That's a good play by them bringing pressure right up the middle. Linebacker blitzes, speeds up Brewer's read, couldn't get the ball out to Lovett that fast. So that's what you need to do. You need to bring some pressure. Make Brewer uncomfortable back there while he's trying to throw the ball.
Lovett stays in the backfield. He'll get it on second and 10. Their leading rusher each of the last two seasons spins his way for good yardage. Got seven. Shy of the first down by three. And let's see. 2 minutes gone by in the second quarter. They're going to go with Pace. So Brewer, play call right at the line. Run pass option. Can he get there? No. Didn't work. Good job by the Lumberjacks on that side of the field. Didn't bite on the misdirection. Burt Morris, the first one, the middle linebacker, who stayed home.
That was great, great reads. Look, everybody stayed at home, played their responsibility, didn't fall for the fake. Linebacker stayed back there, didn't go with the offensive line moving one way because he knew he was going to keep it. They tried to go around for the boot. Great play by Morris on that, reading his keys, keeping eye discipline, and watching his responsibility, and that was Brewer.
It's a fourth and six, looking like they're going for it, but we'll see if they're just trying to get him offside and then call a timeout. They still have all three of their first half timeouts left. And will it be? No, they're going for it on fourth and six, and a timeout might have been called. It was by the defense. So Stephen F. Austin, they'll set it up defensively. We'll come back on fourth and six for the Bears.
Courtyard Waco, Irwin Construction, George's Restaurant, Waco Hilton, Spice Village, and Toe King of Waco. Your support of Baylor Athletics.
Baylor fans, turn your attention to the end zone. We are here for the Douglas DCM Tiger Race. We actually need mini kids. I mentioned it, just kids. They're going to be racing the mini Tigers across the finish line all the way to Brewer. We have Keely, we have Elliot, we have Ty, cars 1, 2, and 3. You guys ready? On your mark, get set, go!
Scott Power, defensive coordinator for the Lumberjacks. His squad is playing their hearts out right now because they put in a bad position in short fields every time for Baylor.
Absolutely.
And now looking at a fourth and six. Just a little intense, and we don't blame them. We like it on the opening Saturday of the season. So inside of 12 to play in the half. And Baylor going for it. Short field on fourth and six. Ebner. And a little turn in route complete. First down, Denzel Mims working on Artavius Hendricks and did have a lot of room, but a good throw by Brewer.
Yeah, great slant route. It gets open, doesn't allow to touch him, gets the ball out of his hands really fast. Brewer saw the slant play. If you saw, DB was just playing too back. Hendricks was playing too far back on that play.
Mims held him up, and then he took a shot at the end of the play.
Denzel Mims with the catch.
There was no whistle. You can't blame Stephen F. Austin. Bottom line, there was no whistling. And the right rush in, Ahmad Murray came in and laid the lumber on him.
Got to go to the whistle sounds.
So it's going to be second and 10. Charlie Brewer so far. 11 of 16 for 111 yards with a couple of strikes and a couple of scores. It's Ebner blocking the back. That helped. Now adjusting, Ebner coming over to the near side. Can he get to the goal line? Touchdown, Baylor!
coach said that at this point, he would be one of the special guys with the big play ability to go out there and make some plays. And that's exactly what Tristan Ebner did. He reversed field, had the defense going one way, and is able to turn around. They run an option play, kick it to him, but he's just so fast, so quick with his big play ability, outruns the defense, finds a hole, and if you watch downfield, the receivers kept blocking. They didn't give up on the play, understanding that this guy has some big play capabilities.
So once again, they capitalize on a short field, but it's points off a takeaway. The interception by Blake Lynch. Point after, Mayers pushes it through. Good work by the junior from Henderson, Texas. So Tristan Ebner with a 21-yard touchdown run and a 21-7 lead for the Baylor Bears. Short field, a pick, an interception by Lynch, and another touchdown. Ebner's already got two of the three for the Baylor Bears. Welcome back to Waco once again. Joel Myers, Barrett Brooks, and our cast of thousands here for ESPN+. Big 12 now, 4 minutes gone in the second quarter. Back deep. As a pair away to the goal line, Xavier Gibson. Along with Remy Simmons. And it'll stay in the end zone. I want to remind everybody, you can catch the Baylor Bears challenging the very best college Olympic sports teams in the nation on Big 12 Now, ESPN+. Starting September 12th, soccer, volleyball, and it continues through the season. Soccer, volleyball, you'll see every game. Don't miss a minute. Sign up now. It's the Big 12 Now at ESPNplus.com. You see just some of the events. Field position, that has been controlled by the guys on top by 14, as this is going to be the sixth series in the first half for the Lumberjacks, of Stephen F. Austin getting it at their own 25. Self with a gun, but throws it short. Receiver went down, tried to scoop it for him. That's tough because he was available.
Yeah, he was on that play. Self needs to calm down a little bit, sit back, get his head about him, and then throw it. I mean, that's pretty much, you know, indicative of how this drive's been. He'd been punt, punt, TD, punt, interception.
It'll be second and 10 at the 25. Plenty of time. Pocket holds up well underneath at the 30. Couple of extra yards. Calvin Clater doing a good job. The sophomore from Fort Worth. Tall target. Lynch and Tejada over there combining on the stop.
He took his time. Read the defense. Took what the defense was giving him. That little stop right. He was able to execute the play. He needs to slow his game down a little bit and execute the offense.
Needs a little more than three, almost four. On third down, running back, big hole, closed in a hurry, though. Short of the first down by less than a yard. So he tried to take him on, the running back, and the first touch for DeLeon Ward. He thought he was going to bulldoze him, and he's short by half a yard.
This has become a definite experience for this punt team. I mean, we don't know what we're going to get from this punter.
It's been difficult. Max Quick. He's had a couple of issues. One with penetration and a deflection, and then a real short one, of course. Got this one away as best so far and kept it away from the D-back who was waiting. Graylin Arnold. Good job. That's the best job. Remember when Hal Mumme was at Kentucky, he said the ultimate is kicking the ball out of bounds for your punter. Right. No return.
Well, if you look at it, he's taking too many steps when he's punting anyways. He's stepping into the teeth of the defense before the ball leaves his foot. So it's a probability that it might get blocked again if he continues to go so slow with his footwork trying to get the ball out on his punts.
You see the numbers so far for Charlie Brewer, but Barrett, this is the worst field position they've had to start a drive. A little more than nine to play in the half, and they've got her to their own 19-yard line.
They have to go out there and make a play, get some yardage.
Making a miss. Good job at the backfield because there was penetration. Hasty made the most of it. The senior from Longview, he's brought down by Gordon, the safety. It'll be a gain of about four, and those were four tough yards.
Coach Rule has made it a point to make sure he emphasized to his offensive line that they have to be better. And this is where I want to see this offensive line get it going.
Good grab. Thrown a little bit behind. And then could be a personal foul, and it will be a personal foul as Fleeks made the grab. And then a meltdown by Gavin Rowland.
Can't do that. Mistakes are what kill teams.
Eli Jones came in. And I think it was Jones. Rowland was the first one over. And then was it Jones who punched it away? You're looking at unsportsmanlike, personal foul.
After the ball is down, dead ball, personal foul, late hit, number 26, defense. 15 yards from the end of the run, automatic, first down.
Eli Jones, who came in late after Rowland made the initial hit, the strong safety.
What was he thinking? Play has already stopped.
Yeah, that's a meltdown.
Coach Carthel is losing it right now.
Can't blame him. A lack of discipline. First and 10 of the 45. Inside route. Man, what a pivot. What a move. Beautiful work by Denzel Mims. First down out of bounds at the 34.
Brewer's starting to get it now. He's sitting back in the pocket, allowing it to develop in front of him. He sits in the zone, is able to go out there, make the catch, and then make some guys miss.
So quickly from their own 19 all the way to the 34 of the Lumberjacks. Hasty. And a good job up front by Stephen F. Austin.
Bakari and Nichols. They are the strength of this defense. Both of those guys played last year. They've been in big games before. They know if they can solidify things in the middle, stop from running, make this defense one-dimensional. Make them pass. Then they got a shot at stopping them. That's exactly what they did when they did make them turn over on downs. This is exactly what they need to do. Get some penetration, control the interior of that line of scrimmage. Then you can get some pressure on Brewer.
It's manageable right now, Barrett, but you can't let him march 81 yards and get into the end zone again before halftime. 7.5 to play with the clock moving. Now Brewer, ad-libbing, going deep in the end zone. In and out of the hands, but boy, oh boy, Chris Platt almost made an amazing catch. The penalty is going to be on the young man who just picked up the mark off, Eli Jones, who picked up the personal foul.
He's having a battle right now. Got turned around.
Pass interference, number 26, defense. 15 yards from the previous spot, automatic, first down.
Yeah, that's 30 yards on Jones.
He has a man-to-man on his play. He's so wide open because he got him turned around.
And almost a phenomenal catch by Platt.
He almost made it.
Man, oh man. So take it down to the 19 now, first and 10.
They're killing themselves right now. Yes, Brewer's good, but he's not as good as they're making him be right now because they really need to go out there and stop him.
Making mistakes. On the play fake, in the flat, Ebner, a little bit of a block from his wide receiver. Down to the 16, gain of 3. And forced out by Bird Morris, the sophomore from Amarillo.
Quick offense. Get the ball out of his hands.
And only one timeout left for the half for Stephen F. Austin.
Offensive coordinator Nixon giving Brewer quick reads just to get the ball in his hand, get it to his athletes, and let them go out and make plays.
Mims moving over, shifting the tight end, Henley, over to the near side, trips on the wide side. It's Need, and he's short of the first down. Quinn Jones, strong side back, did a good job. The senior from Abbeville, Mississippi. His third on stops last season for the Lumberjacks.
Just a quick wide receiver screen. Get it to the receivers, have some blockers in front of them.
We've already seen a number of those, haven't we?
Absolutely.
It'll be third and two. Big hole, left side. Will Ebner get there? Yes! Unbelievable! Didn't look like there was any way in the world. Third touchdown of the game already for Treston Ebner.
Big play capabilities. That's exactly what Coach Rule wanted. Just get the ball up out of space. Hand it off. Run backside. Reese is blocking. But then he just has the will to just keep going. I won't be denied. This young man wants to start. He wants to be a big time player. And he's definitely showing his coaching staff that he's ready to take the reins and be that back star back for him.
So the worst field position to start a drive so far for Baylor, but it didn't make any difference as they just traveled 81 yards. Mayers for the point after. And now a 21-point cushion for the Bears with a lot of time still left in the half. Ebner, the man of the moment right now.
Gold Pepsi. Delicious, refreshing Pepsi. Grab a Pepsi and some friends and get in the game. Pepsi, the official soft drink of your Baylor Bears.
Make your own seat. And what an atmosphere they have now. The ballpark before, it was a lot of history. It was a lot of fun for all of us. But this is amazing. It is a beautiful situation they have now on campus in Waco, Texas. And welcome back once again, Joel Myers, along with Super Bowl champion Barrett Brooks. The Big 12 now on ESPN Plus as the Lumberjacks are ready to get it back. Tressen Ebner has taken over. Short fields, that haven't hurt. That has not hurt the Baylor Bears. That was the long drive.
They've been hurt themselves.
Yeah, mistakes by Stephen F. Austin. And the kick, not returnable. But we remind you, the first four episodes of Miles to Go, they got to be entertaining because it's less. They're available now on Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. All Access Series, and chronicling the first season of new Kansas head football coach Les Miles. New episode available each week throughout the season. Miles to Go. It is streaming exclusively on the Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. I remember, God, meeting with Les in his office at Oklahoma State.
Wow.
Just a little while ago.
I didn't meet him in his office there, but I did meet him at LSU. So.
Yes. Coach O doing a good job since taking over there in Baton Rouge. Now, first and 10 from the 25. Self in the flat and a good make a miss move. And good yardage across the 30 out to the 33, taking it in. Ward, the running back, to Leon Ward, brought down by D'Souza. And we heard that he was going to get some minutes, this young man. Neadre Zuzwa is from Brockton, Massachusetts, transfer from Monroe Junior College. And penetration up the middle. Henry Black was the first one, and he was on his back as well. And they're short of the first down by about a yard, yard and a half, caught it.
They're going to have to move the pocket a little bit. James Lynch has got a bead on his offensive tackle, left tackle. And he's whooping it pretty good. So you're going to have to move the pocket, run some boot protections, maybe bring in an extra blocker to help him out. Because Lynch is having his way.
So you're saying it's just not fair?
No, not at all.
Thank you. Third and short. Self doesn't need much on the deflection. Falls incomplete. He tried to thread it through. He's going as Clay Johnston. Got a piece of it. He's going for Cody Williams.
And Clay is just such a good player. Senior, single number. He was able, through the pressure, to sit back and deflect the ball down the field.
And what about Bravion Roy, senior from Spring, Texas? He was in the face of the quarterback, wasn't he?
I mean, his hand placement, way he's rushing at center, he's pushing him around also. So everywhere he goes now, Self is getting rushed from every direction.
R.J. Snead waits for the punt back at the 25 of the Bears. Quick. Another short one. And off the side of his foot. This is going to be on the other side of the 50 again, I believe. Unbelievable.
Wow.
This is a tough day. Tough day for the young man. So the problems, well, the personal fouls, they don't help. Markoffs, 15 yards right there. That's the quarterback, Eli Jones.
Turned right back around. Later in the drive.
30 yards.
Pass interference.
So two 15s and Ebner cleaned up.
The will to win could not be denied.
And now another short field. Five out of seven possessions. Baylor has had it in Stephen F. Austin territory to start the drive. Jamichael Hasty. Not much over to the left side. Good job that time by the front seven of the Lumberjacks. Sampson over there. They play a traditional look 4-3 set. Sampson, yeah, an underneath tackle.
They have to get a little more penetration. Make Brewer uncomfortable. Run plays, get penetration.
On the play fake, blitz picked up, middle dropped. And it was there.
Oh, yes, it was.
And available. So Fleeks couldn't hang on, the sophomore from Dallas. But a good throw by Charlie Brewer.
Great throw, and Brewer read it perfectly. In fact, he sent the running back over to pick the blitz from the short side of the field, just showing his maturation as a quarterback, had the right protection in, just didn't execute on the pass play. They've got to catch things like that because, I mean, at this point, this offense could be pretty prolific if they go out there and execute.
So now third and a long seven, almost eight. Hasty stays in the backfield. Pocket holds up, and they've got the first down. Complete to Denzel Mims, and when they've needed a big play on third or fourth down, Mims has been the guy he's gone to. Hendricks on the coverage.
He's becoming that safety blanket. He's now starting to look for him. And at this point, Mims is starting to make it happen.
Getting testy early. It's hot outside, isn't it?
Absolutely. Defensive line doesn't want to be out there that long. They want to go ahead and stop him. But when you get first downs, keeps them out on the field a little longer. Mims one-on-one. Stop route. Turns back around and come back. And makes a play. On their best cover man.
Hasty will pick up the outside blitz. Wide open in the end zone. Out of the reach of Mims. Wow. So that time Charlie Brewer missed. And he hasn't missed many. He's now 17 of 24 passing.
He wishes 155
yards.
He definitely wishes he could have that back.
Wow. That was there. And he had beaten his man by a lot.
It's almost looked like it's a coverage problem. But he's just beating him on a man-to-man coverage.
Double move, little stop start.
Taking candy from a baby.
Man. Behind Hasty. And then he's belted inside the 35 by Quinn Jones. Sure-handed tackler.
Good eyes by the defense. Get the running back out there on the little speed. We call it a speed screen when you have all the receivers out there blocking their guys. And hopefully you can get a one-on-one with the running back. He runs away from the linebacker. But, hey, these guys pursued.
Jeff Nixon, the offensive coordinator, making some calls upstairs and some very good ones. Movement up front. And was there contact? Was there contact by the tackle on the right side? Defensively. You saw the left guard put his hand up.
I think he was making a call, and these are discipline things.
Offsides, number 83, defense. 5-yard penalty. Remain third down.
Another mark off against the Lumberjacks.
You can't hurt yourself.
Okay, I was going to say 83 is a wide receiver. They call it on Williams, the defensive end. Makes it easier, manageable. Now third and three.
Pre-snap penalties are unacceptable. Penalties alone are unacceptable. Pre-snap, them you can help.
Seal over to the right side. Jamichael Hasty's got the first down. Good read by the running back.
Get him out of space.
He's a fifth-year senior. Already has his degree in kinesiology.
Wow.
There are 15 players for Baylor that have already graduated, and 10 are in graduate programs right now.
Unbelievable.
First down. Hasty again. Had a good job coming up off the edge. The linebacker, Burt Morris. Otherwise, there's a lot of space. But Burt Morris, the sophomore from Amarillo, he showed up a few times now.
Yeah. And you know what? It's a great thing that the NCAA has now where a player can play 4 games and still red shirts, which gives them a lot to get their feet wet, allow them to play. And then red shirt, a lot of them mature a little bit, get their college bodies. And then they can come back and play at a better level because they're more mature. And then it also allows them to go further in their education.
Without a doubt.
So win-win.
Yeah. Find out what it's all about. Get some reps. And not lose a year. Big hole. Huge hole. Inside the five. Touchdown, John Lovett.
Starting to beat him up front. And this was an offensive lineman. You want this. Offensive linemen love this part. When you start running ball and then they can't stop you, look at that hole he has to run through. Great execution on the double team. Runs off the double team, and then he just uses his talent to go play. Lovett was their leading running back rusher last year. South Jersey kid.
I don't know if they're going to put him at safety anymore.
I doubt seriously
because he's
now
been a two-way player in the past.
Yes, he has.
Mayers in for the point after. And 35 of the board now for the Bears. It doesn't seem like there's that huge a disparity, but the field has been so short for Baylor. Yep, Stephen F. Austin, their special teams are killing them right now.
Killing
and
them.
It's made it easier for Baylor.
Mistakes.
But coach is positive, isn't he?
Oh, he has to be. I mean, he has a young team. You know, at this point, they've done what they hadn't done before. They scored on a Baylor team, hadn't done that four times. They were out scoring, what, 200-something to nothing. So, I mean, that is a feather in their hat. They stopped them on a couple drives on the offensive side of the ball. They long drive for a score. It's just hard for a team as young as the team that they have right now to really go out and compete with a team to start to turn the corner. And then Baylor has definitely started to turn the corner. Coach Rule has put his guys in a position where they believe in what he's going to do, and they're executing.
It is a warm evening now in Waco, Texas. Game time temperature 91, 92 degrees. It felt like it was close to 100. And it hasn't exactly cooled off.
No.
Although it break because the humidity was at about 50%. You and I have both been here where it's like more 80 or 90%.
Right. Where it feels like your skin is melting off. That's how hot it is outside.
Our camera at that end, it's on the band side. That vibration. So a little more than two to play. I mentioned it. It's not like the NFL. Clock will stop on the first down, of course, but still only one timeout left for the Lumberjacks. Good kick. And Noah Rauschenberg, a true freshman from Tulsa, kicking off for Baylor and taking the return game right out of it. So once again, it'll start at the 25 for Stephen F. Austin. Five times out of their eight possessions, it has started at the 25. They've had no field position is what it boils down to.
Making them earn it.
And five of the seven for Baylor, five of the seven times they've had it, they have been in plus territory. So Trey Self and the offense back out there. Let's see if they can build, even if it's only three, a little confidence going into the locker room, a plus. A junior from North Richland Hills, Texas, back out of the gun. Pocket collapsing. They almost got him. And he'll get out of bounds. It's kind of funny because we were talking to the coach yesterday.
Coach No.
And Coach Rule.
Coach Rule
in
Lovell,
particular.
Yes.
And also Coach
Nixon.
Nixon, Jeff Nixon, the offensive coordinator, about his quarterback getting down. Because the backups for Baylor are both. One's a redshirt freshman and the other's a true freshman. You got to keep Charlie Brewer out there.
Exactly.
Although Bohannon did play a little bit last year. On the spin, not much available. It is Ward, the running back.
You know, defensive coordinator Phil Snow has implemented a defense that moves a lot, shifts a lot. D-line is penetrating. And it's hard for this offensive line of Stephen F. Austin to pick him up, which is putting them at different levels. When you're at different levels in the offensive lineman, you can't double team, you can't get movement. If guys are flying around, it's harder on your running backs and eventually your quarterback to really make plays because they don't know where the blitz is coming from. They don't know where the guy's slanting to. So it's really hard as an offensive lineman to work in concert, and that's exactly what it is as an offensive lineman. You have to work in concert with each other. It's almost like a big dance. And both guys have to make sure they're on the same level drive blocking, and they're not getting that from the offensive line.
By the way, can you read lips? I can't, and I'm just wondering why all those screens just went up. That's a first for me. Have you ever seen that?
Yeah, they're trying to keep everything secret. I don't know, you know. Well,
our cameras are pretty good, but No.
Not that good.
And there is Phil Snow, the defensive coordinator. So they wanted to improve. You brought it up at the top of the telecast, the 3-3-5. And he said they don't want to be predictable. They've got a lot of playmakers. They're going to take the ball away. They're going to get picked today. So they've got one takeaway. They only had 10 all of last season. Here comes the heat. And it's wide and over the top of Tamarick Pace, the senior from Brownsboro, Texas, on third and long. And that's why they called the timeout to get it back now.
It's getting to a point now where I don't understand it. They are getting pressed back so fast that Self can't make any decisions to really get the ball out on time. Look at left tackle. He just shoves him. I mean, it's a tough day, a real tough day for Self, and even tougher for left tackle Zach Ingram.
Let's see if we get a better kick from Quick. Line drive. It'll be brought back. This time. And Snead is put down quickly. Good coverage downfield. Banned for Stephen F. Austin. It's Miles Hurd, the safety.
Great coverage. Hopefully the defense comes out and stops them. They're going to be looking to keep those guys up front from penetrating. Get Charlie Brewer a chance to really close it out, because I don't think they'll have him out there in the second half.
Well,
at this point, I mean, it's 35-7, and we talked to Coach. You know, Coach Rule said that he wanted to play all his guys.
Yeah, he wants participation.
Yes.
Everybody to get on the field whenever possible.
So, I mean, 35-7 is one of those opportunities, you would think so.
So now Baylor, first and 10. Ball to their own 22. Low snap. Brewer. Man, throws it away outside of the pocket.
Good job.
Yeah, avoids a loss. It was going to be right at the line of scrimmage anyway. Morris got into the backfield, flushed him out. It's interesting, the schedule this year, the last 2 years, Baylor has had a Power 5 conference team, and they're non-conference scheduled. And Barrett, that's not the case this year. So after home games tonight, Stephen F. Austin, and then Texas San Antonio, then they hit the road for the first time. They're going to play at Rice on the 21st, an American Athletic Conference opponent. Gun. Brewer's got it. First down. It's going to be Snead. R.J. Snead, the sophomore from Cypress, in front of the corner on that side, Caleb Lawton.
Dropped it in the dime. Great pass.
Stops the clock momentarily with the movement of the chains from the 40. It's first down. And should have been picked.
Ooh.
Poor throw by Brewer for the first time. But Trenton Gordon, safety, the junior from Roland, couldn't get it.
Now he has the time. They tried to get a go route in the middle of the field in the slot and try to sit him down. And Charlie has to see that. Charlie Brewer must make sure that he sees that undercut on the route, on the coverage. The coverage was zoned. And they're going to have a guy that's going to squat out there. And the corner squatted on that pass play, was able to make a play on there.
Second and 10 from the 40. Middle of the field and almost picked off on the deflection. Safety back there almost got to it. And Lawton was there. It was a deflection, though.
Same scenario. They're running zone. They're not high-lowering the receivers. They're sitting back in the zone, keeping their eyes, and letting everything develop in front of them. That way they can try to make a play and react. They're not even trying to hide their covers from Brewer. Brewer has to read these better, understand what he's getting, and make the appropriate throw.
So now third and 10 from the 40. Screen, Ebner. He'll be short. He bounced around for about four. We'll see where they mark him out of bounds. And a punting situation coming up for Baylor. It'll be just their third punt of the first half.
Really good job by Scott Powers and his defense. Changing it up on Charlie Brewer. Running zone instead of playing so much man. Not blitzing, sitting. They sat back five guys. Let the guys up front rush.
Bentley waits back at about the 15 for the punt. Short one, fair catch. He's got it. It'll be at the 20. So it is rare when you see this many possessions. This is the ninth series for Stephen F. Austin. Final minute. One timeout on the board. And let's see if they can move it and at least get into field goal territory.
This is totally up to Trey Self. settle down, run the offense. And at this point, Zach Ingram, it's mano a mano. You have to step up, young man. You're 6'7", 300 pounds. You got to get down, drop your hips, and block the guy in front of you. And now it's Lockhart. We'll see what he does.
Once again, in the backfield, that man, James Lynch. He busted up the play right away.
Right away.
Man.
And they put him on the inside this time. He wasn't a defensive end. Look at him out. He's in the middle. Gets up the field at nose guard and makes a play.
You could put a single digit on him the way he's playing.
Absolutely.
If you don't know, 1 through 9 on the Baylor Bears, those are the 9 coaching staff. That's an honor. The coaching staff gives 1 through 9 to the 9 toughest.
The 9 toughest player on the team. Those single digits mean something for this Baylor team. If you have a single digit number, that means you're one of the toughest guys out there. And at this point, I think Lynch should be one of those guys.
And that'll be the final snap of the half.
6 of those guys that have the single digits are on defense. So this goes to show they have a major emphasis on being tough at this point.
So in the start of his 3rd season, a very strong beginning for Matt Rhule. And Colby Carthwell on the other side, he knew it was going to be a process. A lot of newcomers in the program for Stephen F. Austin. 35-7 at the break. It's the Baylor Bears comfortably in front.
Today's Friday. I'm going to see my
halftime continues in Waco, Texas. Baylor on top of Stephen F. Austin by 28. Well, the new ESPN Plus original series, Miles to Go, takes viewers inside Coach Les Miles' first few hours on the job as he flies with his family to be introduced as the head coach of the Kansas Jayhawks.
Today's Friday. I'm going to see my son play on Saturday. Then that next morning, they're going to fly me out of there to Kansas. And then the Kansas itinerary takes over. I meet the team, press conference, donor meetings, all et cetera. Put myself in a position to lock up my coordinators.
I'm so excited for you to do another game board.
Yeah, exactly right.
I saw the picture with the
it's just a selfie.
Victory on it. What do you mean? Is that a selfie? No, because we're not holding it. If we were holding it would be a selfie. Now it becomes a selfie.
I got you.
Selfie guy or no? Today's the day. We're headed to Lawrence. Going to see the new home. It's kind of crazy in the coaching world how you've never been to a place and you choose the place based on the football and then you move there and make the best of it.
Rob Chalk!
Thank you. Welcome back to balmy Waco, Texas. Yeah, what a start. Third year for Matt Rhule in Baylor. And a real strong beginning, especially for his quarterback, Charlie Brewer, a natural leader. And Charlie has delivered. He's a junior out of Lake Travis High School in Austin. He has started now 17 of the last 18. And they like his leadership to the point where you see his numbers, but the real story is the way he's calling out protection. So normally it's the center, but he also can trump the center and make adjustments and call those coverages as well on the offensive line. So a great start for Charlie Brewer and the Baylor Bears. And let's not forget about Trustin Ebner, a guy with three touchdowns as well. A couple on the ground, one through the air, and it's been a commanding performance over the first 30 minutes of play. Baylor by 28 at the break in Waco.
Dr. Pepper.
There's a storm coming.
Did you hear that? Someone's in the house.
All of our Dr. Pepper's gone.
Hey, you got the wrong fan!
Oh, are you seeing another grill?
It's just a snack.
That's it, Croak.
These turnovers are killing us!
Your husband's gone.
For the season?
United Way is focused on community banks and community-led solutions. In partnership with the community, the organization has advised the most vital needs to eliminate barriers to a good quality of life for all Midland and Kemena residents. United Way raises, stewards, and invests funds to help strengthen the cornerstones of life for education, health, financial stability, and safety net services. This year, $1.2 million of the community's dollars were invested in high-impact programs with the capacity and the purpose to change lives. United Way Impact brings ensure children are born healthier and inner school ready to learn. Young students persist in school and parents are active and engaged. Individuals have access to preventative and mental health support. Families are able to be financially resilient and secure. And those in need have support to move beyond a crisis to stability. Baylor University supports the Clinton County community by streamlining its employee community giving through the United Way of Waco and Clinton County. Please direct your attention to the view where you will find United Way of Waco and Clinton County campaign ambassador, Julie Hayes. United Way board members, resource development chair, Danny Gunn, president-elect Andrew.
Continuity and consistency, as there have been reps for the Baylor Bears, the guys that have performed at a high level over the first half. Charlie Brewer, we mentioned that. Well, Barrett, so has Trustin Ebner. Ebner has been outstanding at the tailback spot.
Yeah, you look at him, he's definitely changed into one of the threats of this Baylor team. Talking to the head coach, he said that at this point, Ebner has shown the ability to be a big play guy. And Nixon said the same thing, offensive coordinator. He has a skill level, which, he has to be a big-time athlete for this team. He's essentially somebody you would say has an opportunity to make it to that next level, especially with his drive. You see that play? He just willed himself to get into that end zone, fought for it, and was able to accomplish it.
Not a bad start to the new season with three scores. See those kids? Those young men and women? The freshmen.
They're ready.
And there's a good story behind the freshmen here that we'll get into when we come back, because they are a part of this and the way it all begins at McLane Stadium on game day. Welcome back to Waco. It's our Dr. Pepper Campus Moment as we look at today's Campus Moment brought to you by Dr. Pepper. And it all has to do with the way things start here. First of all, if you're a freshman at Baylor, you are honored because you are putting your name, your signature down as they walk into the stadium. That's how the players come in. They're on the yellow line. Well, so are the freshmen. This is how they come in right before the Baylor Bears, and they take their positions. And now the Bears come in. It's a really healthy situation. Great atmosphere. Successful program now. They're building with Matt Rhule at Baylor.
On an all-new season of Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
There's a storm coming.
Did you hear that? Someone's in the house.
All of our Dr. Pepper's gone.
Hey, you got the wrong fan!
Are you seeing another grill?
It's just a snack.
That's it, Kroger.
Turnovers are
killing us! Your husband's gone.
For the season? I'm transferring to Tech.
Dr. Pepper, the official drink of Fansville. About time you showed up.
I'm ready for Dr. Pepper. I don't know about you.
Absolutely.
Warm night in Waco. Welcome back once again at 35-7. And let's see if there's some adjustments now for Stephen F. Austin. The defense for Baylor, let's not forget James Lynch, what he's been disruptive.
Everywhere they've put him. On the outside, he's really put it on Zach Ingram. Outside presses him. Those are all things that, you know, a quarterback is looking for. You're not changing the scope of the game. Lynch on the inside played nose guard, was able to make a play behind the line of scrimmage. He has become a major force and a major factor in that coach's defense. And you love the fact that Coach Rhule didn't even say anything about him, and this guy's really been a focal point on creating pressure and havoc wherever they've put him, whether it's nose guard or outside a defensive end. He's been a major force in this defense.
Well, Baylor was dead last in the Big 12 last year, giving up 26 plays of 40 yards or more. Well, they're not going to be giving up big plays with a guy like that in the face of the quarterback and that kind of penetration early on snaps.
Exactly. No, Zach Ingram, I mean, we're talking about a guy that's 6'7", almost 300 pounds. He's been given all kind of pass rush moves, whether it's running straight through him, knocking his hands down on the outside. He's really making it hard on Trey Self to do anything back there, especially throwing the ball. He's even being disruptive when they put him at nose guard and stopping the run. So I tell you what, them changing to this 3-3-5 defense has really allowed them to put their best athletes out there.
There you see the Big 12 preseason poll as where they picked the Bears to finish this year. And also remember, Baylor didn't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They only had 25 sacks last season. That was the third fewest in the league, ahead of only Kansas and your alma mater, Kansas State.
Absolutely. And, you know, Coach Rhule understands this is an up-and-coming program. He's not letting it get to his kid's head. He's make sure they're grounded. And you can tell by the way they're playing because there's not a lot of guys going out there creating penalties, hurting the team. They're being focused. They're running the offense. Brewer is allowed to run the offense and now check to different defenses, check to the defense blitzes. If there's somebody coming off the edge, he'll redirect the offensive line and go over there. Or even as far as telling a running back to go pick up this blitz on the opposite side of the field. That's his maturation to become a better quarterback in this Big 12.
Yeah, we spent a long time yesterday with Matt Rhule, left it in such a positive vibe. Okay, we're ready to play now, too.
Right.
And we felt good about it, and then we met with his coordinators. But you can understand how he can relate to the players, how he can communicate. Great communicator.
Yep, and they don't think that they're going to be sixth in the Big 12. They have bigger dreams and aspirations here in Waco.
Now, the Bears, up 28, are going to get it. Jamichael Hasty over to the near side. Over to the far side, Josh Fleeks waiting for the kick. And let's see what kind of field position. A very good kick. But that's a pick-me-up. So Storm Ruiz got into it. And now Baylor is going to have it at their own 25. Let's see also if they just keep it on the ground a little bit.
Well, any positive gain is a great gain. And that kick was definitely something positive for the Stephen F. Austin special teams to work with. They've been virtually horrible in punt situations. Maybe kickoff situation, they score a little more. They could put themselves in a better position.
So Charlie Brewer, in the first half, productive. Didn't force it. Almost had one pick, though, on a poor throw behind his receiver. He was 20 of 30 for 178 yards with two touchdown tosses. And a huge hole. Lovett on his way into the secondary. Lovett with a big, big run.
You got to give it up to them guys up front. They totally smashed the backside of that defensive line. Watch how they just cave everybody down on the right side and just brings them with them. I could run through that hole, and I'm 6'5", 340 pounds. It's easy for a running back to pick that hole up and have some positive yards when you have holes like that on the backside.
You know, I know we're up here and we're high, but I didn't know we were mile-high elevation after that comment by you. From the 37, rather. It's Lovett making a miss. Good yardage on first down.
That offensive line is starting to take control, moving the defensive line, which is supposed to be a strength for the Stephen F. Austin defense. So once they start up and, you know, start blocking like this, it could be a long, long, even longer day for this defense.
Got nine, second and a yard. Third consecutive, made the most of it. Well, and then you go back to the experience on the offensive line, and you mentioned it. Tecklenburg, the left guard, started every game last year at center.
Absolutely, and he is one of those guys. He should have a single digit, but he came off on the block. Even then, double team, comes up on the linebacker, and then drives him back, and all the running back did was just get in behind and move.
They'll throw for the first time of the second half, and grab is made out of bounds, though.
Nice touch by
Good
Brewer.
Effort by Snead.
Just bring it back a little further.
How close was he to bringing
Very
it down
close.
In bounds? And out of bounds.
Yeah.
And by the time he controlled it, the knee's down out of bounds. Great effort. Man.
They have a lot of confidence in Brewer. You can tell. And getting more and more confidence with throws like that.
It'll be second and 10. Opening 90 seconds. They are under reviews. You can hear that in the background. Well, and then don't forget the center started every game last year at left tackle. Jake Frumorgan, the senior from Tampa, his transfer from Clemson. Now, does he get any part down? Well, he hits the pylon,
he hits
doesn't
the pylon.
He?
So if it is a catch, it's a touchdown.
Wow.
Great concentration.
Does he control it?
That's the problem. We need to see.
Yeah, he did. I think Great. He controlled it.
At this point, you don't want that to happen if you're defense.
It is simultaneous right there at the catch and the pylon.
He secured it.
Big 12 officiating crew looking upstairs right now.
You know, Scott Powers doesn't need that to have his defense pushed around like that. First drive in the second half.
No, it's an improved offensive line, though. The left tackle, Connor Galvin, he started six times as a as a freshman last year. And then they brought in the transfer from Snow College, who was second-team JUCO All-American last year, Blake Bettier. And then they have a redshirt freshman at right guard. So they've gotten better up front, and you can see that.
You know, Tecklenburg is an aggressive guy, strong, great core, comes off the ball, and he's starting to drive, which is supposed to be the strength of this Stephen F. Austin defense. He's starting to drive Bakari and put his hands on him and keep him from making plays. And you see it starting to wear on him because Nichols is also starting to lag a little bit. And once you start lagging and lack the effort of getting off blocks, that's when big runs come to running backs like Lovett and Hasty. And then, you know, when Ebner comes in, you know he has big play potential every play.
Cal McNeil, the referee, getting the final word from the booth review. I mean, it was close.
Very close. But understand, if it's a catch, it's a touchdown. He hit the pylon.
That's usually in every part of the field, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
One last
secure
time.
Right there.
Catch, hit the pylon.
Foot down, hits the pylon before he goes out. Look at the concentration.
I like the way it went parallel. You know, he left his feet to get to it.
But had still conscious enough to get that left foot in, though. I mean, right foot in.
Just brought it in.
Looked like a catch to me. He secured the ball, brought it into his body.
Great work by our crew. Good angles. Good angles, good camera work. What do you say? We got to make a decision up here. Come on.
My decision is, it's a touchdown.
I'm going to say no.
Not just a catch, it's a touchdown.
I'm going to say no. I got to go the other way then. If you would have said no, I would have said yes. This is going to, I hope the barbecue doesn't close. What time is it locally right now? Five after eight? That's a key consideration here. Great barbecue in Waco.
You're talking about an offensive line, but you know I love to eat anyway, so.
Yeah, I couldn't tell.
But they talked a lot about this offensive line in our meetings with Coach Rule, Coach Nixon. They believe in those guys up front. They say that's the biggest progression that they had this year in training camp, the offensive line stepping up and really taking control. You know, although they were as good last year, they made it a point to be a lot better. It's a concerted effort to make sure that they were dominant this year. And I think they're on the right track right now, starting to take this game over and putting it out of reach of Stephen F. Austin.
All right, let's see what our referee and the booth review has come up with.
At the review, the ruling on the field, the ruling is touchdown.
Touchdown.
You're 1-0 and I'm 0-1 to start the new season. And R.J. Sneed has his first score of the new year. The sophomore from Cypress, Texas. He laid out to get to that. That was a phenomenal grab.
Great ball by Brewer. Sneed goes and gets him. Has the body awareness to come down, hit the pylon, and for the score.
It was 35-7. It's about to be 42-7, and we're barely into the third quarter. The Mayors gets the extra point. So that's the way it begins. Sneed celebrates, and the Bears get more. An auspicious beginning for the third year of Matt Rhule.
your Baylor Sun Ladies. D1 Waco, the official training partner of the Baylor Spirit Squad. Don't miss the Bears in action versus UTSA on Saturday, September 7th, for our Bear Foundation Appreciation Game, presented by Premier UR Urgent Care. Kickoff is scheduled for 3 p.m. Get your tickets today at BaylorBears.com/be there to be a part of all the excitement in the stadium. Fans, vote on the winner of our Whataburger hashtag battle. One entire section is going home with a coupon good for the free Whataburger. Check back for the winner and make it in the second half.
She lost some strength there. You know. This is the Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. Welcome back to Waco, Texas. Joel Meyer, Super Bowl champion Barrett Brooks, a cast of three or four. It's a 42-7 game. Baylor on top of Stephen F. Austin. Baylor coming off a pick-me-up season. 1-11 2 years ago, second season with Matt Rhule after taking over and coming here from Temple. 7-6 with a 42-35 win in the Texas Bowl over the Commodores of Vanderbilt. So there's a lot of momentum around the program coming into the new season, and they're not disappointing to start this one. It'll be out of play, and it's going to be a touchback as Stephen F. Austin will get a first and 10 at their own 25. It was a 14-0 game, and then Trey Self and the Lumberjacks got it together and made it 14-7. But ever since, it has been dominated by the Bears of Baylor.
I mean, they're in a transition right now. I mean, Colby Carthel takes over this program. It was already a deflated program when he did pick them up. So he's trying to bring some self-worth to these guys. And it didn't help that they're coming in with an up-and-coming Baylor team. It didn't help their spirits.
Yeah, and ask Matt Rhule at 1-11 his first year.
Exactly.
He's already experienced it. Self, the running back, Ward will get it. And over the left side for about three, up to the 28. So there's no question, Colby Carthel is going to turn things around, in my estimation.
Absolutely.
At A&M Commerce, they won a national championship. And gaudy numbers, his overall win-loss record there.
Was
phenomenal.
Yes, unbelievable. You know, he's one of those guys, you know, coaches with enthusiasm. He expects his players to play like he coaches also.
Play fake, design roll. And wide of the intended target, he is looking for pace. Coverage, Graylin Arnold.
They're trying to get him out of the pocket. Run a little sprint right.
Yeah, just move the launch point.
Move the launch point. That way, keep rushes out of his face. And, you know, he has to throw a better ball. That was a bad thrown ball. You know, he had him at two levels. They high-load the defense. They had some players to make the play. They just didn't. He didn't have an accurate throw at that point.
So now third and seven from the 28. With the pocket hold up, moving, buying some time. And the comeback trail, is it a trap? Is it a catch? And they're going to say incomplete. Outstanding effort by Cody Williams, though, the senior from Pearland, Texas.
Yeah, I mean, he tried, but, I mean, he's got to get a better ball. It might have been a little contact also. So, yeah
it's on
he's got to throw a better ball. You know, and there's that man again, Mr. Lynch, from the nose guard position, rushing the passer, came around on the loop, fast enough to make an impact on Self's throw.
Graylin Arnold waiting for the punt for Max Quick. And a much better one. And put on the ground, but Arnold got a good hop right back to him.
Ooh, that was close. Very close.
So a returnable tie, but that's why you see his frustration. But a break for Baylor as they're going to have it at their own 37.
Baylor's light shines around the world, but it starts in each of us. Baylor. where lights shine bright.
All right, fans, it's time now to tackle the helmet shuffle. But don't let that McAllister's famous ice tea distract you.
It looks like his ninth grade picture, but no, it's the junior quarterback, Charlie Brewer. We should all look that young.
Absolutely.
Good for you, Charlie.
I'm jealous.
Does he shave? So, a good start. No picks. One that was off target a little bit, but boy, the quarterback rating is going to look good. And Jerry Bohannon's taken over at quarterback, and look at the wheels on Bohannon. But the new quarterback can run. Bohannon. What a start to the new season for the redshirt freshman. Two-time state of
straight speed.
League City, Texas made the stop. That's Gavin Rowland. But, man, 6'3", 220. He's got wheels, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
He's two-time All-State in Earl, Arkansas. He's got it from the 41. Good decision. Another guy who's had a really good second half already. And that is John Lovett. He was carrying the rock early in the second half for big yards and setting up the touchdown on that 75-yard drive to start the second half.
And you know what it is? The offensive line up front is starting to take over. Those guys are starting to play smash mouth football. And as an offensive line, you love this point of the game.
You know they're going to you. There's no question about that. It's Lovett. And he's got another first down.
And, yes, they ran the same play over again. Just basic inside zone, and the back is bending it back. Having a lot, you know, waiting to make sure the play develops in front of him, gets his blockers out in front of him, and he just cuts right off of him. John, I love it.
Yeah, John, and you got to love it. As John says, a junior from Burlington, New Jersey, who, as Matt told us, he recruited him to Temple.
Yes, he did. And then took him with him.
You got it. Bohannon on the play fake. Good strike. Man, it's complete for another first down. Taken in by Jared Atkinson, his first target of the night, the junior from Mesquite, Texas.
Watch him get it. They run a boot. Boot turns around, gets around, swings his hips, throws an accurate ball on the outside. Nothing but a little flag route. Pitch and catch.
You got it. Real simple. So 6'3", 220 pounds. Doesn't look 220, does he?
No.
Hasty bouncing around inside the 10. He'll take it to about the 8, brought down by Quinn Jones.
Watch this move up front. Get him going up front. Drive block him. Double team there. Double team point of attack. And just get in behind your blockers. They call us the big uglies. Well, there's nothing ugly about me when I was out there, but they call us the big uglies up front.
Don't get carried away. I know it's late, but don't get carried away here. Yeah, and it was good luck because the center, Jake Frumorgan, he got one. He was looking for more.
Exactly. Give me some more.
He already blocked one person. He was trying to get a chip on another. And nobody accounts for the wide receiver. Touchdown, Baylor. And Tyquan Thornton, the sophomore from Miami.
Once you start moving guys up front, They lose their discipline, no longer look on the outside where their responsibilities are on defense, thinking it's a run. Look, everybody thinking it's a run play. Watch the linebackers. Bite on the run. Leaves them all out there by himself. I mean, he just stood there. I'd have threw it to him, too. I mean, look at it. Wide open. Nobody even accounted for him. That comes with running the ball successfully. When you can run the ball and the defense can't stop you, it's hard on you for even to even do anything else but stop the run.
Another extra point for John Mayers, the redshirt freshman from Flower Mound, Texas. And 5 minutes gone in the third. Baylor comfortably in control. God help me. How do they line up here? I think they forgot about somebody.
All by itself, sitting out there, and that just comes with you running the ball. You no longer look for the first thing you can do to a defense is run the ball, and they can't stop it because it makes you, you know, triple the it triples your sense of what your assignment is. Now you can't just concentrate on your assignment. You're trying to help somebody else do their thing, and once you start helping somebody else, it's like a triple effect. Now you have to help them. You can't help yourself. Somebody else is looking to help somebody else. It just triples all the worst things you need to do when you're trying to stop a defense, stop an offense.
Oda be young and totally uninhibited. I never had enough rhythm to even consider it. Want to remind everybody, one of the big benefits of Big 12 now on ESPN Plus is access to Coach Matt Rhule. Catch his weekly press conference every Monday. It's live every Monday morning during the football season, 11:30 Eastern, 10:30 right here in Waco, Central Time Zone. Just one more reason. Sign up. Big 12 now. Go to ESPNplus.com. And a likable guy. Really enjoyed talking to him for a long time yesterday. And happy to be in Waco, Texas. After a successful run at Temple.
Great guy.
Misses the restaurant, though, in Philadelphia. We know that. On first down.
Loves Italian food.
What? Who doesn't? And especially in South Philly.
Right.
The carry by Ward. So this is good for Colby Carthel, too. because some of the younger guys on his squad are getting an opportunity to play. As a junior from Dallas, getting some reps. Ward, the running back. Trey Self, this is his first game at this level. He was at Butler Community College last year. From the 30, it'll be second and five. Little flanker screen, and that's not fooling anybody. Out on the edge, an outstanding play. And into the game, it was Jaron McVay who made the play, the junior from Richmond, Texas.
Get an opportunity, go out there and make a play. It gives you more playing time. That's exactly what they did. He went out there and made a play. You're just trying, if you're a young guy out there and you don't get many reps, when you do get a rep, make sure you make an impact. And when you make an impact, now the coach start thinking, can I trust you? And you go make a play like that, he will then start to trust you.
Catch by Borders was a loss of about three, so now it's going to be third and eight. Pressure. Got rid of it in time, though. And Borders collared. Clothesline, but he's got the first down. Good effort. Keep across the 35.
Keep the sticks going. Here he goes across the formation. Runs across the formation. Sits down in the zone. Able to make a play. Now it's just Will. Well, I don't want to be stopped from making that first down. He won it. He wanted to go out there and make it happen, and he did.
Terrell Bernard, the weak side backer. Sophomore from LaPorte with a jolt on him. So the clock rolls, 8:20 to play in the third. On first down. Ward had a little giddy up, but that was shut down in a hurry.
Yeah, it was.
Bernard again involved. Well, this is big for the defense, too.
Watch the inside backers. Come up, Phil, and then makes the play. Offensive line, you got to drive. You can't just let him go. He wanted it more than the offensive lineman wanted to be there.
He's working against a true freshman there. And you have to, as you said, engage and drive.
Right.
Make sure that he doesn't get out. On second and long, underneath route works, and a first down. Another pop taken, and this time the catch made by Miles Brooks.
See, it's a
or
good
check
job.
That five, not six. It was Calvin Glater.
And this is where Coach Carthel teaches his guys never to give up.
Now was their helmet involved. You saw Glater go over to the sideline, and he felt it.
Yeah. At times, you know, it's hard with the momentum and the intensity these guys are playing at. Sometimes it happens.
Pass interference, number 19, offense. 15-yard penalty, previous spot. Lay second down.
That's Gibson. So the other wide receiver is called for a push-off. Wow.
Yeah, it's
come on. The D-back engaged him just as much. That was JT Woods, the sophomore from San Antonio.
Yeah, they both can't occupy the same space at the same time. So, you know, it's hard as a...
I don't blame Colby Carthel, though.
Know, it's hard with a ref, you know, because in real time it does look like a block, but it looks like, you know, he wanted to get there and the DB stopped him from getting there.
After the mark-off, good grab. Great catch, and yards after the catch. Biggest play of the game.
Wow, that's a great read. That's a great read by the offensive line. Picking up the blitz. Watch the inside. On the inside, they ran a cross-backer blitz, and the running back comes and picks up that outside backer. Great job giving Self enough time to get the ball down the field. A really good route thrown catch. They should have been doing this in the first half, but at least they're not giving up as a team.
Xavier Gibson, biggest play of the game, yardage-wise. I don't want it. You take it. He will take it. And a good run. Because there was kind of tug-of-war between Thomas Hutchings and the quarterback on that handoff.
Yeah, Thomas didn't know whether he was going to take it or the quarterback was going to give it to him. We didn't know. But look, if you watch his patience, he stops. He doesn't get, you know, too nervous about it and then makes a play. Runs straight through the line. And the line's coming off. That's what you want. You want your line to come off. They're getting some success because they're controlling the line of scrimmage. The boys up front are starting to win.
putting together a nice drive now. The screen to the wide receiver. That's Cody Williams. That almost went for big yardage, too. Good play call.
Yeah,
and the offensive coordinator, Matt Storm, dialing up some interesting ones now.
Yes, sir. He has to, because at this point, you look at the offensive line. That was a speed screen. Get it out to your specialist, and then allow this offensive line to pick off some of these linebackers and safeties down the field. Open it up a little bit.
So second and short.
Oh.
And he had Cobb in the end zone. Couldn't get it.
Yes, he did.
Senior from Dallas was available, though.
I love what Coach Carthel's doing. He's allowing his guys up front to get a little help from the running backs. You saw that on the right side of the offensive line. The running back came over, tapped the offensive tackle on the outside of his hip, letting them know that he had him on the outside for a chip. When you keep more guys in, it gives you an opportunity to go down the field. But hey, you have to make sure that the guys you have out on the passing routes can win on their routes.
It'll be third and short. A little more than a yard. And a missed handoff. That was busted play, partner.
Very smart by self. Making sure he didn't take the sack on it. He opened up on the wrong way with the running back. Called out no man's land. Yeah, I was a quarterback on that play because he was supposed to reverse to his left instead of reversing to his right. To run with the read effect and then come on out with a boot to the right.
Field goal try coming up. And not a bad idea. Get some confidence for your kicker, Storm Ruiz. And it is blocked. Rolling towards the end zone. And it'll come back out. So the block up front, it looked like the true freshman at 6'5", 305, Gabe Hall from Waller, Texas. Whoa. Good penetration, not a lot of resistance. It is the second block of the night for the Baylor Bears. And they were exceptional last year, led the country. And it was seven. So they get two tonight on a punt and a placement. And now they get it back to their own 20-yard line. JaMychal Hasty going nowhere. It'll be second and 10.
That was actually a major concern for Coach Carthel. He really respected their special teams play, so he made it a point to his young team that's what Baylor loves to do. Make big plays on special teams because it really puts you in a position if you are lacking at any point in offense or defense, it can make up for the inequities.
Bohannon could have had it picked, and it looked like it was going to be picked.
Oh, yes.
Quinn Jones, he was ready to run with the football, the outside linebacker, the strong side backer.
Great lead. He read the play, uncut the play. Look, undercut the route on that. He was actually beat. If he'd have thrown it on the outside, it might have been a great play, but he undercut it, realized he had to get between the quarterback and the receiver, and made a great play.
It's a redshirt freshman quarterback who just came into the last series, Jerry Bohannon. So Charlie Brewer done for the night. Delay goes nowhere for JaMychal Hasty. Timing is everything on that play, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely.
And it's a new quarterback as well.
Yeah, they have to get back into a rhythm. I think they need to go back to really doing what they did on the first series, first drive. They just really put it on them. Ran in between the tackles, blasted them up front, double-teamed them, pressed the line of scrimmage back, created a new line of scrimmage 3 yards down the field, which allowed the running backs to hit the hole and understand and read the blocks in front of them.
Bentley waits for the punt now. Been a long time. You got to go back to the fourth series of the game since they went three and out with a punt, the Baylor Bears.
Prior to the snap, the leg game, kicking team. 5 yard penalty, remain fourth down.
That'll make Coach Rule go crazy. He expects perfection even from guys that are coming in who aren't necessarily starting the game. But you will play at a high level if you're in there, whether you're a starter or not.
Well, they got on the field late to begin with. Now, Isaac Power hits it from right around his own goal line. He did get a punt. And there was a substitution, and that's why you see the official come running in. So both are allowed to.
Well, the ref's not allowing him to snap the ball, so
right.
They can wait.
Reset it.
Reset, yes.
Fourth ball, delay game.
No.
Kicking team.
That's because obviously the
main fourth down.
They initiated the substitution, and the other team has their opportunity to get a player on the field. It's first game.
Yeah, you want time on the field, you got to make sure you know what you know. And that was one of the things that Coach Rule stressed. No stupid penalties, no substitution penalties.
Good one by Power. And backpedaling, Bentley has it back at about the 40-yard line. So in a 49-7 lead, Stephen F. Austin and Trey Self, the offense back out there. You can catch the Baylor Bears challenging the very best college Olympic sports teams in the nation on Big 12 Now on ESPN+. It starts September 12th. It'll start with soccer and volleyball. And it continues through the season, so don't miss a minute. Big 12 Now. Sign up at ESPNplus.com.
Yeah, you know, sometimes they say no penalties, but there's sometimes when there is a good time to take a penalty. And I've had plenty of quarterbacks like Rodney Pete tell me, hey, I'm glad you had that holding call, because when you have Reggie White coming at you and bearing down, you don't want him to hit you full speed, so he would take that flag at times.
Breakdown in the secondary, and the completion is a long throw and a long gain, and it goes to Lawton Reichel.
Yeah, move the pocket once again, get him out there. Good protection by the offensive line. Definitely in zone coverage.
That's Ward again, and he is belted in the backfield. That was Jordan Williams, the senior from Paris, Texas, on top of that play. He was into the backfield right away.
Bryson Jackson getting penetration. Sometimes it comes down to just whooping the guy in front of you. And at that point, Jackson, at the point of attack, did his job.
3 minutes to play in the third. It'll be second and long after the loss of a couple. And pressure on the quarterback, Trey Self. It was Neandre Zuzwa, the junior college transfer from Brockton, Massachusetts. Nice little loop as well.
Yeah, they love running this cross dog. We call it a cross dog when you send a D-line one way and then you bring both linebackers around the corner. And it really is almost an instant pick situation for the offensive line because you're at different levels. And usually 9 times out of 10, if you don't have a back back there, he comes scot-free to the quarterback.
Good play again, though, by Jordan Williams. He was the first one in there. So now third and long after the sack. And look out. Self delivers. It's complete. Graylin Arnold took care of the running back, Hutchings. And it's going to be fourth and long, still on the short one.
There you go. Get the ball out your hands. Try to make a play. Self is trying. He's running for his life. But he's trying. At this point, there's no way that you can complete a pass with the pressure that he's having in front of him at this point.
So the punt comes. It's going to be Graylin Arnold waiting back deep. Close to getting to the punter again. And a short punt that rolls back out to the 15. So that's where Baylor is going to get it for their fourth series of the second half. Big 12 now on ESPN Plus. It's there for all you Big 12 fans. Exclusive home of more than 50 men's basketball games. Hundreds of other Big 12 sports like women's basketball. Plus original content. The weekly Les Miles All Access show during the college football season. And watching his first year in Lawrence, Kansas. Sign up today at ESPNplus.com. They're all smiles with good reason. When Baylor gets it, they'll put it to the 14 now. First and 10. Bohannon stays in at quarterback. No, it is Zeno in at quarterback now. It's Jacob Zeno. He wanted to get a lot of guys involved. Told us that yesterday. And was that Bohannon? Is Bohannon still on the field? Okay, it is Bohannon.
Yeah, but
from eight stories up, it looked like another number.
Well, let me look at this offensive line. This is the second team offensive line. And, you know, you want more playing time. This is where you earn it as a second teamer. Go out there and show that you can play against whoever you put in front of you and move the crowd. You have to understand that at any point as a second team guy, you could be a starter. And this is where you get a lot of approval from your coach. If you can go out there and make things happen, then a coach is more comfortable in letting you in the game, especially in situations where you're coming in as a reserve guy when the starter's hurt.
Well, and now you've got, as you said, you just saw Big 77. Jason Moore got in there. He's 6'3", 300-pounder. He's a sophomore. He's the backup guard from Frisco, Texas. So these games mean a lot to a lot of guys because they get an opportunity to get on the field. Little dump-off works. It's complete and close to another first down. Taken in by Fleeks, the wide receiver. Sophomore from Dallas. And that'll probably be, let's see the play clock. Will it be the final play of the quarter or not?
I love the fact that they're still fighting. This Stephen F. Austin defense, tired. They've run a lot of plays today, but they're not giving up. They're still playing hard. It's a lot of adversity, you know, looking at that scoreboard up there and still wanting to come out. But just goes to show the intestinal fortitude that you must have.
And then as you saw the other side, as Colby Carthel with Stephen F. Austin, he's got to be proud of his guys to hang in there. But you saw Matt Rhule. You couldn't believe by looking at him that it was 49-7 at the end of the
Absolutely.
Third.
At Baylor, our lights shine
while we push our limits
and guide the way.
At Baylor, our lights shine as we're making connections
and making an impression
as leaders
and as part of something bigger.
Baylor's light shines around the world, but it starts in each of us. Baylor, where lights shine bright.
Now, don't you wish you had that kind of energy? After three quarters, 90-plus degrees, humidity's up there. And what's with the hooded sweatshirt? I'm sweating watching.
Absolutely. I can't believe I play when I play, but there's kids out there in fur.
Wild. Welcome back to Waco. Joel Myers along with Super Bowl champion Barrett Brooks. Ball on the ground. And it looked like it got out of bounds before it was covered. No. Recovered by Stephen F. Austin. Coming up with the football. It was the defensive back, Roberts.
Defense.
Got to keep fighting. Stephen F. Austin.
Yep, good cover.
They understand that this is a young program. I went through this before when I first got to college, Kansas State University. Bill Snyder comes in. We were ranked 106 out of 107 Division I schools. Nobody wanted to come to Kansas State to play the Little Apple. But he turned it around, blood, sweat, and tears. And that's exactly what they're experiencing right now at Stephen F. Austin.
I enjoyed Fridays. Meetings with Coach Snyder in the Little Apple. And on first down after the takeaway. And now it's even in takeaways because they had a takeaway earlier on the pick. It was an interception earlier by Blake Lynch of Baylor.
They got to keep fighting. I mean, this is the starting offensive line for the Lumberjacks. They're going against the second team defensive line, a defense of Baylor. They should make some headway. They should be able to control the line of scrimmage.
Let's see if that transpires on second and four. And a bolt tripped up. It is McGowan on the carry, the junior from McAllen, Texas, who led them in rushing last year. Not many touches so far tonight. Hutchings has seen most of the duty.
So many three and outs to really run the ball in the second half, so you're not going to run a lot. But at this point, you have nothing else to do but go out there and make sure that you run your offense. This is going to become almost like a practice, and you have to execute the offense 9-on-7 with the big guys up front, see if they can control the line of scrimmage against the twos of Baylor.
You got to only need a yard here, Barrett. And bouncing outside, Hutchings has it. He's driven out after the first down at a gain of about 5, down to the 16. Graylin Arnold, the safety came up, but a good read to get out to the boundary by Hutchings.
If you watch Hutchings, he set his blocks up. He dipped inside, which made the defense jump inside, and then bounced it outside. He did it twice, really setting up the block, making sure that they were reading him going inside, which allowed him to get outside and get the first down.
So Willoughby points off a takeaway. The one thing Baylor wanted to do was create more turnovers, not give it away. Yeah. That little flanker screen did not work. Graylin Arnold all over it as it's brought in and then quickly put down. It is Xavier Gibson.
He's got to do a better job of setting his blocks up. He didn't do it what the running back did the previous play. You have to make sure when you catch the ball, secure it first, number one. Then set your blocks up. Dip outside a little bit. Get the defense going outside. Then cut it back in on the speed screen and try to set up your blocks on the outside.
It'll be second and 9 from the 15. Self on the jump ball. Man, on the 50-50, Clater ran into the defensive back on that side of the field. Got a good job on that corner. Off the bench. Play was made by Bernard.
He might have a little bit to say about that, but they didn't call it.
Hand spart actually, the cornerback. Yes.
But you got to get stronger as a receiver. Go up and get it. That's the difference between a great guy and an average guy. The want to win.
Third 9, you got to believe after having a couple of kicks blocked. I wonder if they go to another one. If they don't convert. Grabs May, but it goes nowhere. That was Chris Miller, the safety, who came over and pounced on Cody Williams, the wideout.
Wide receiver screen. Got to slow down a little bit. Secure the catch.
That's an honorable mention. All Big 12 performer last year, Miller. Well, they will try it.
The kicking game for Stephen F. Austin has been an adventure. Every single time the special teams is on the field, you don't know what you're going to get.
Last attempt by Storm Ruiz. What a long one. It was blocked. This is going to be a 32-yard attempt out of the hold of Cam Arnold. And success.
Oh!
So points for the first time since very early in the game for the Lumberjacks.
Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus is a must. Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus is a must for Big 12 fans. It is home to more than 50 men's basketball games, 200-plus women's basketball and Olympic sports events, original content, coaches' press conferences, and shows. Big 12 Now is available on your phone, tablet, desktop, or TV-connected devices. Sign up today at ESPNplus.com.
Baylor comfortably in front after the field goal by Stephen F. Austin. Welcome back to Waco once again. So 49-10 with a little more than 11 to play. And Ruiz ready to kick it away for the Lumberjacks. It'll be a short one. And take it at the 5. Drop down almost immediately. Fleeks, the wide receiver. It's interesting because in looking at the numbers, Barrett, yesterday head coach Matt Rhule told us last year they didn't have the choice. They wanted to run it more, but they ended up throwing it more than they ran it because the ground game wasn't as efficient. It's kind of like the numbers right now, though. He's got 242 passing, and he's got 184 on the ground. Good balance.
Great balance, and that's exactly what he said yesterday. He wanted to have a 50-50 type of balance where we're not pigeonholed into just doing one aspect of our game, and that's exactly what they're doing now. And they said because the offensive line has gotten better, they have the autonomy to do that. It's not forced upon them now to just throw the ball. Now they can dictate what they want to do on offense.
They get it now as Bohannon's going to stay in there. And on a run-pass option, he'll call his own number and good yardage. So he's got it for a good gain across the 25 to the 26. Going back to what Matt was mentioning yesterday with the balance, he's deeper at the offensive line. He goes, you got to remember, though, he goes, the seniors on this team, I'm the third head coach they've had. That's wild.
That's tough. You know, you think about it. You want stability. That's why you go to college, because when you're a football player, you want to be with a coach and be there all 4 years with them. And the fact that these kids have had three different head coaches, that's the most mind-boggling, because you put a lot of trust in the reasoning of you going to college for your head coach.
It's going to be a timeout called by Colby Carthel and the Lumberjacks with 10:26 to play. So we will do the same in a 39-point lead. Stay with us as we continue in Waco, Texas. Baylor Bears, a program with a lot of momentum now, and it started last year after only one win 2 years ago. 6-6 going into the bowl game, and then the win. A huge beating Vandy by 7. That's how you get a program going, and you build. And you said the word sustainability.
Yes, sir. You know, Coach Rule told us yesterday that it was the game before to really set the tempo going into that game.
Yeah, their win over Texas Tech. They were down at the break.
Yep.
And they came back and they beat Texas Tech in the last regular season game. And that was huge for them. Adjustment after the give and a good carry. Well, the tailback, Jones.
He feels that they gave him a lot of confidence going into the bowl game and really turned his program around. They trust him now.
Yeah, there's a different feeling, and they've got a magnificent facility. And you know how it is when you're recruiting. They need a yard, and I don't think they got it. Looks like they're going to be coming up short. But young men, you bring them in to recruit them, and now their physical compound is magnificent. They have the facility.
Exactly. You have to have first-class facilities to get these top-tier recruits to get to come to your school. I mean, the expectations now – it's different from when I was getting recruited in college. These colleges now, you not only have to have great facilities, but you have to have uniforms to match, you know, different uniforms. And, I mean, it's crazy what will bring kids in as opposed to when I was getting recruited in college.
Get back to the thought about recruitment and then competing at a high level in this conference. Good play action fake. Bohannon, he's got the first down. Well past the 40, out to the 45, almost the 46. We got into the quarterbacks in the Big 12, and we've been talking a lot tonight about Charlie Brewer, the junior quarterback, and how he's going to play at a certain level, because here you had Kyle Murray last year. Year before, you had Baker Mayfield.
Wow.
And we can go on a list of guys, not just those two, but this is a deep conference quarterback-wise.
And quarterbacks will win championships. You know, it's definitely like that on NFL level, but the college level's turned the same way, especially in this conference. There's, you know, two Heisman Trophy winners the last 2 years in Oklahoma from this very conference.
Timeout's coming. Stephen F. Austin. They got one left. 8:45. It's a teachable moment. Don't forget for the Lumberjacks. And I don't blame Colby Carthel at all.
Because he's got slot machines. And it's only a 2-week meet and monster payoffs. And I got to give Tom a call.
We've been going over some of the quarterbacks. What about the new coaches as well, Barrett, and one at your alma mater in the Big 12?
Yes, sir. Chris Klieman. I mean, at this point, he comes in and, you know, he changes it up from Coach Snyder departed. So, I mean, it's also the quarterback for the Eagles, his old coach, you know. So, I mean, he has some history.
Well, you got 10 teams. You got four new coaches. That's a pretty high percentage.
Yeah, Neil Brown, West Virginia. Les Miles, Kansas.
Nice spin.
Matt Wells.
Yep.
Taking over for Cliff Kingsbury, leaving his departure to the Arizona Cardinals, NFL.
That was Abram Smith. And here's he's getting everybody involved.
Yes.
Back to what Matt Rhule told us. He goes, if I can, I want to get every guy in the game. So, and that makes everybody feel included. That's great. To have that mindset to begin with.
Absolutely.
Especially when you've been through a camp and the heat and the time you've put in.
That's why he's a great coach. But, I mean, look at it. Just like they deserve it.
That's the fullback. And that is Kobe Bullard. He's the only fullback they list. At 6'1", 230. Remember I asked him about that.
Yeah. Yeah, they run a boot. Turns his hips. Fullback runs across the formation, get it out to him, throw him a bone every once in a while. See, fullbacks are they're not just blockers, they are receivers also. And, you know, got to throw him a bone every once in a while for running into linebackers.
Well, that's getting everybody involved. That's being inclusive. And that's what Matt Rhule said yesterday was, if I can, I'm going to get every guy in the game if possible. And now with the new rule, and you brought it up early in the telecast, where redshirt freshmen, our fresh true freshmen, can play four games and then make a decision. And you can sprinkle those four in anywhere you want.
Exactly. You don't pigeonhole them into making it the end of the year or the beginning of the year. It really gets their feet wet before, you know, you redshirt them. You know, see if they can compete at this level. If they're not, their body's not ready, you give them a year that they can go in and a year, another year, to get their NFL, their college bodies ready to go out there and compete.
Jones, a running back again. Initial contact didn't get him, but he is finally put down. And a good job by Tony Picardi.
Scott Powers, his guys, defensive coordinator for Stephen F. Austin. He has his guys up front still fighting, penetrating. And you know, if they should. That's the second team offensive line for Baylor. Picard. They should be out there trying to wreak havoc.
Well, and that Picard is the starter, the senior from Mansfield, Texas.
Exactly.
They'll sleep well on that bus trip back. They're driving back to Nacogdoches tonight.
Nacogdoches.
3 hours away.
Eastern Texas.
Now, we have a false start.
Delay game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
6:09 to play.
Yeah, we talked.
We haven't had very few flags in this game.
Absolutely.
Knock on wood.
And that's what Coach Rule wanted. Coach Rule got his guys going, and we asked him about if this game becomes a blowout. You know, what is your conceptually? What are you thinking about? Do you really put an earnest on scoring, you know, a lot of points? Does it help you go into maybe getting into the playoff system? Said, no, man, I just want to make sure all my guys play. They had a really tough camp. They deserve to get an opportunity to play, and that's exactly what he's doing. He's a man of his word. He's playing guys that wouldn't necessarily play through the season or if it's a tight game.
I like his backup quarterback, don't you?
Oh,
the escapability.
He's quick as a cat, isn't he?
Gary Bohannon, redshirt freshman from Earl, Arkansas. You just saw on that play the stop, the move, and the extra 4 or 5 yards.
He is so quick.
It is warm downstairs, everybody. Still very warm outside. Yep, he looked. Nothing available downfield, and he makes the play. Down to the 20, and out of bounds inside the 10, first and goal.
I tell you what.
Yeah, he's got great his footwork. He can get out of the pocket and make plays.
This wasn't a designed run. This is actually a pass, and he decided to use his own athletic talent and get out there and run. He is cat quick, running away from linebackers. I mean, it takes a DB to go get him. This guy's really fast.
Earl, Arkansas. You ever been there?
Never heard of Earl, Arkansas.
Two-time All-Stater there. 6'3", 220 pounds.
So one thing I know from Arkansas is Jason Peters played in Arkansas. He was an all-world tight end in Arkansas. Offensive lineman for the Eagles, long time.
And in another touchdown. Yes. Touchdown Baylor. Abram Smith, the running back. Everybody getting some touches and succeeding tonight.
Reward him. Reward him. Watch this. The backside of it, look, double team up front, works up to the linebacker, gives him an opportunity to get out there in space. Receivers block it down the field. It's a total effort, not just the offensive line blocking, but you see receivers down there working just as hard as they do on passing routes when they're going to get the ball. They're blocking, making sure they give an opportunity for their guy to go in there and score. That's all you can ask from a coach, total effort from everybody on the field.
And the placement is good by Noah Rauschenberg, not John Mayers. So Rauschenberg only handles kickoffs. He's on the board for an extra point. And a 56-10 lead for Baylor. 46-point lead for Baylor on a successful opening night in Waco. Welcome back once again. 56-10. It'll be the fifth time they've beaten Stephen F. Austin.
They're still hype. Even though it's hot outside, they're hype.
We were young ones. Just don't remember.
Baylor full of energy.
Bentley back deep, waiting for the kick. And Rauschenberg just got the extra point, so the true freshman from Tulsa. He's on the board, in the books forever at Baylor with an extra point. And Bentley will stay right there. Not Ray Bentley, Romello Bentley. Ray's out of eligibility. First four episodes of Miles to Go. They're now available on Big 12 Now. That's Big 12 Now on ESPN+. All Access Series chronicles his first year as the new head coach at Kansas. So Les Miles in Lawrence. New episodes going to be available each week throughout the year. Miles to Go, streaming exclusively. It's the Big 12 Now on ESPN+. It's a little different than Baton Rouge, Lawrence.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
No redfish in Lawrence.
Yeah.
No drum, no redfish, no crawfish.
I can remember going there and they were grilling alligator, full alligator, 8-foot alligators. Ooh. On rotisserie.
Yeah, I'm not a gator guy.
I'll try anything once, man.
Yeah. And once was enough?
I absolutely tried. And that was pretty good. It was pretty good.
I'm ready for it. Tastes just like chicken.
Actually.
How are the frog legs? Tastes just like chicken.
Actually, Joel, it does. It does taste like chicken.
You'll find rabbit on the menu there, too. Can't do that.
Nah.
Like the bunnies too much.
Yeah, too much Bugs Bunny for me to see that.
Unfortunately, this is what you worry about at the end of games, especially when everybody's been. And it's T.J. Franklin, a true freshman from Temple, Texas.
Wow.
Don't want it.
No.
This
is tough.
It stinks.
You know? It's the nature of the beast. You know, it's good. A gladiator sport.
He's
I'm glad
up.
He's up, yes.
Yeah. Warm night. So Cam Arnold is in, the new quarterback. Redshirt freshman from Cypress, Texas at 6'1", 205. So he gets an opportunity at the end of the game. Trey Self, up until this point. Self, his night is over after going 15 of 29 for 140 yards. And he was under pressure the entire night. His offensive line just couldn't hold up.
Yeah, and that's kind of what happened with Trey Self. You know, the pocket was just collapsing too fast. And, you know, it was a tough competition going into training camp between the two of these guys. And Trey Self won the competition. And, you know, they said this kid is right there. And also Coach Carthel said he'll be playing a lot during the season. You know, it's not just him locked in itself. He's also given this kid an opportunity also to go out there and play a little bit.
So now he's looking at after the sack. It is going to be 3rd and 11. Utley got the sack, and you could see the enthusiasm for a guy to get that opportunity late in the game. Now Arnold running for it, and he's got it. Across the 35, resourceful.
Yeah, you have to be. I mean, if you look at it, they're in man coverage. Man coverage, everybody turns around and goes to their man. He takes advantage of it, gets up the field, creates a first down. Got to keep fighting. Show these coaches you can play.
Just got under Tecklenburg there. Squeezed that final yard out of it. Arnold again. And a good touch. Finds his wide receiver who takes a belt.
Oh.
Got popped. And he goes down, but hangs on. Josh Thompson with the first down.
Get him moving around in the pocket a little bit. Get it out there. You see, two receivers in the same area. They high-load him.
Serious sandwich he was in the middle of.
Right.
Clock moving. A little more than 2 minutes to play. Just get out of here healthy, guys. Man,
right up the
dash.
Middle.
Josh McGowan with good yardage for a first down.
Offensive line starting to take over a little bit. Playing against the second and third team of Baylor.
How did you stay hydrated on a night like tonight?
Pickle juice.
Really?
That was my little secret.
No, I've heard. I've heard other guys have used
drink
that.
Drink pickle juice.
Yeah. Do you have to put a clothespin on your nose?
No, I actually like pickles, so it didn't
work. I do too, but I'm not drinking juice.
Well, you know, when you play in situations like this, your body, you can lose anywhere from 10 to 15 pounds of water weight.
Great run. And does he get there?
Great effort.
Yes. Thomas Hutchings, he's not quitting. The senior from Cedar Park, Texas.
They took him out on the one.
That's tough. You did all the work.
Bust through the line. Guards are to get up on the second level to the linebackers. Now it's one-on-one with a corner who's not necessarily wanted to go up and tackle a big running back. They don't choose to do that. Most corners you say, oh, I'm cover guys. I'm not a tackle. I'm a cover guy. When you have to tackle a big guy like that, you got to come lower. He took him on too high. He was able to go out there and make the play.
Cam Arnold out of the gun. And touchdown. Josh McGowan. So something to feel good about to get on the bus, the three-hour ride back to Nacogdoches tonight.
Amen. You know, his team has not given up. Coach Carter loves it. They go in, double team at the point of attack, allow his running back to go in and score. And, you know, Baylor had an irregular defense, you know, no excuses. They still scored. It gives your Stephen F. Austin team something to go home about. That they at least kept fighting till the end. And that's what coaches do. Coach Carter's building a team. Baylor is almost complete with their team.
Point after by Ruiz. Man, with 64 seconds left. He'll come back to Baylor, and they'll run the clock out. Well, next Saturday, Big 12 Now on ESPN+. More college football for you. Kansas hosting once again Les Miles' squad. One, they beat Indiana State today. They've got Coastal Carolina next week, and then you're going to be in Stillwater at Eskimo Joe's with the guys. Oklahoma State matching up with McNeese. Both games starting at 7 o'clock Eastern, 6 Central. So sign up right now. It's the Big 12 Now on ESPNplus.com.
Yeah, I got the mullet next week. I've got the mullet.
You do?
Yes, sir.
All right. I like it. They're hanging in there. The attitude, the enthusiasm, home opener. And next week it's going to be University of Texas San Antonio. Next week here for Matt Rule and his squad. And then they're on the road on the 21st. They're at Houston. Or check that. They're in Houston, but they're at Rice, an American Athletic team. So counting the numbers on specials, making sure he's got it. You see
right.
That? Get an abacus over there.
Always
behind
coaching.
The black curtain, they also have an abacus.
Always count. You know, Rice was the first team that I beat.
At K-State?
My freshman year at Kansas State, yes.
Don't forget those, do you?
Indy Kalu. I was matched up against Indy Kalu.
Ooh, what a player. So put it at the 25. We'll schedule. And then it gets tough. Then you get to conference. Iowa State. And Iowa State struggled to win in overtime today over Northern Iowa. K-State in the Little Apple at Cocoa Bolas. Texas Tech, Oklahoma State on the road in Stillwater. West Virginia, TCU at TCU. And then the back-to-backs are tough.
Yes.
Oklahoma and Texas. Man, oh, man.
Two top 10 teams.
Finish it up. Les Miles and Kansas in Lawrence. See you at the Golden Knox. So 64 seconds left from the 25. And it's Zeno in a quarterback? No. Is it Zeno? Well, they made the change. No, it's Garrett McGuire in a quarterback. So the third quarterback of the night for the Baylor Bears. And he said, I want to get everybody I can on the field. True to his word. Good for Matt Rule.
And these kids will love this. They will always remember this. Giving them an opportunity to play. And there are going to be times they're going to play like this a lot. Whether on the winning side or the losing side. He said it doesn't matter to him.
Well,
he wants kids to play regardless.
Yeah, and as a former player, you can appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Those guys work hard all week.
I mean, it's
and
been
especially right out of camp.
Exactly. You know, tough camp, asking these guys to go out there and practice in this weather.
Ball storm, number 78, offense. 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
That's the reserve left tackle, a redshirt freshman out of Dallas, Jack York. But Matt Rhule said the one bit, maybe the biggest difference on his team this year is the depth on the offensive line. He said it's dramatic, the improvement.
Exactly. When you can have an offensive line that can protect and you're deep at that line, it just gives you a different sense on your development as a team. You can do a lot more with an offensive. It all starts in the trenches, and that offensive line is where the ball is snapped. That's where you get your plus yardage.
You're totally objective, though. What position did you play?
I played offensive tackle.
I just had to.
Offensive tackle.
Wanted a total disclaimer in there.
Yeah, look.
By rule, there's a 10-second runoff. Please set the clock to 22 seconds.
We are not complaining.
Clock will start on my ready.
I played left tackle, the money position, although it wasn't the money position when I came out.
Oh, so you're complaining now?
Yes, I'm complaining.
Okay.
I was born 10 years too early. My mom cost me millions.
How would you feel if you were in the NBA 20 years ago? Thank you. That should be the final snap of the game. And a real strong start to the new season for the Baylor Bears in the third year for head coach Matt Rhule. And it's Barrett, it's only getting better.
Absolutely. A lot of positives to take out of this game from both coaches.
Yeah, Colby's kids had held up well. Colby Carthel in his debut as the head coach at Stephen F. Austin, a good conversation with Matt Rhule. And they're going to succeed there. They're going to get much better there. You just look at the track record at A&M Commerce when Colby was there at a national championship. So Coastal Carolina, Kansas, McNeese, and Oklahoma. Oklahoma State, that is. And that's Big 12 football now, next Saturday, when you sign up at ESPNplus.com. For Barrett Brooks, I'm Joel Myers. Thanks for being with us. What a start for Matt Rhule and his squad on a warm night in Waco. Our final score, the Bears 56 and the Lumberjacks 17. Now, all games airing on Big 12 now and on ESPN Plus. They're live and they're streaming as well on the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN. Thanks for joining us. So long, everybody, and have a great weekend.